And Sports Writer of the Year, Jason Wilde.
Is there anything anybody loves more than agreeing with Tausch?
Packers Hall of Famer, Mark Tauscher.
I got a hunch this isn't going to be concise either.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio.
I would say that you are pretty easygoing. You're actually probably more easygoing than I am.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Well, there's no, you're not easygoing at all.
Hey!
On 100.5 ESPN, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Wednesday edition. Day three of Tausch's vacation. Jesse, do you know how long this vacation is lasting for him? Do we know when he's scheduled to reappear?
Sometime next week. I think the Brewers home opener is Tuesday. That might be a target date for old T. I don't even know where he is.
I don't either. He doesn't tell us that sort of thing. Edition. The man, how lucky are we? What is Harbaugh's line? Who's got it better than us?
Nobody.
We've got such a great group of cousin subs of the day. Cousin subs, we believe in better. That we could survive without the straw that stirs the drink just fine. In fact, we don't just survive, we thrive. We had Justin Garcia, a lot of Bucks talk on Monday. We had Bryan, Bulaga, Iowa, yesterday. And we got another one of my favorites. One of my favorite teammates, and I do enjoy telling him how old he is by telling him how much I enjoyed watching him play for the Badgers when I was a kid. Or listening to him play, more accurately, because the games weren't always on TV. We'll tell you who it is next edition of Wilde and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee, 100.5 ESPN Madison, 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam. ESPNWisconsin.com, the ESPN app, your Alexa smart speaker, streaming live video, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and of course everything you could possibly need on WisconsinOnDemand.com and the Wisconsin On Demand app. I'm Jason Wilde in Green Bay. The aforementioned Jesse Nelson is in the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios. And our cousin sub of the day, cousin subs, we believe in better. Live from his own undisclosed location, repping his alma mater, although he played for them much earlier than the Motion W appeared. It is former Packer, former Badger, and I believe at least for 1 year, maybe two, former Lion. It is our friend Gary Ellerson, our cousin sub of the day. Gary, good morning, buddy.
How we doing? We don't talk about those Lions days.
I know we don't, but it still counts.
I would tell you this. When I walked into the Lions facility and my first practice was the first time I ever saw a player sit on his helmet and smoke a cigarette during practice. I was like, what is this?
So was that Wayne Fonts' era? Who was the coach then?
Daryl Rogers.
Oh, sure. Okay.
Wayne Fonts was the defensive coordinator, but he really was the head coach. Because Daryl Rogers went into a meeting, a press conference, and looked around at all the media people and go, what a guy got to do to get fired around here?
Wow.
Yeah.
He eventually accomplished that goal.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they paid him to go away.
Boy. It's quite an operation that you were playing for. Although, you know, the Packers had their struggles too during that era. We're thrilled to have you. I'm being told, because I took a couple days off for the holiday Easter weekend, that the next 2 days you're here, but I'm not, and Tausch isn't. It's you and Jesse?
Is that what I'm hearing?
That's what I'm. That just came across my desk.
Where are you going?
I'm not going anywhere. It sounds like maybe I'll be joining the show just to help the cause each day.
Numbers are going to be in the tank. We're going to need you about 9:30 tomorrow, Jason.
I'll see what I can do.
Be that special guest.
A guest on my own show. I've always wanted to do that.
Oh, you've done it before.
I have. And I'm usually better in that role, frankly.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, Gary, we appreciate that you have stepped into the breach. And I was hoping to talk about a myriad of Packers-related topics because there's some interesting stuff that I think you'll have great insight on, especially as a former running back. But I guess I wanted to start here. And when I look back on this offseason, you know, you have been very, very, very which is it, bullish or bearish? What's the good one? You're feeling confident. What is that, Jesse? I always get this wrong. Tausch always corrects me.
Confident is bullish.
Bullish,
I believe,
right? Yeah, that's what I thought.
Because the Bears are bad, so bearish, what do you think?
There you go. Yeah. That's a good way to remember it. I appreciate that memory device that you just gave me. So you've been very bullish on the Packers. And I wanted to ask you if so far, because we haven't talked much, I think you filled in one other day in the offseason so far. What has transpired from January 21st, the day after the loss to the 49ers, to today, made you even more confident that this team is a Super Bowl contender, is legit, the quarterback is legit, they've added more pieces that they needed, the holes aren't? How have you viewed this kind of two-month span since the season ended?
Well, I can put it to you this way. I think they are a better football team today than when the season ended by the pieces that they've added. Now, I think they got to get more depth and really on the offensive line. You know, there's a couple things that transpire. You know, David Bakhtiari is gone. Yosh Nijman is gone. You lost John Runyon. So I think those three players, you now got to find depth behind those players. I think maybe you still could see that in free agency, or maybe you still can see that in the draft, but you've got to be able to protect your quarterback. And I know we talk a lot about Jordan Love, but I don't think a lot of people talk about Rasheed Walker that much. And really in the year that he had, I mean, I thought early on he struggled a little bit, but came in and played really, really well. And is that real? I don't know. So I think you've got to be able to maybe draft a tackle in the first round. Maybe there's a guard there somewhere that you need. So I still think when you look at the Packers right now, offensive line to me comes to mind where they have to shore up because they've lost a couple people that they need to replace.
Yeah, I said to Bulaga yesterday that I do not believe, I will be absolutely stunned if they come out of the first 2 days, which they have five picks. I know Tausch loves seven in the first 167. They've got five in the first 91. They got a first, 2 seconds, 2/3. I will be stunned if one of those five players, if they keep all five picks, is not an offensive lineman. And that's not me ripping Rasheed Walker. I think, considering where he came from, I thought he played quite well, and there is a chance he could be the guy as a seventh-round pick. But I don't – when I look at where they're at on the offensive line, that is a clear need, even though we know basically they're starting five right now.
Right. It is a huge need. Because what we talked about, the players that they lost and the depth that you need behind them. I would say I wouldn't be surprised out of those five picks, two of those are offensive linemen. Now, they're probably going to look a little bit more on the defensive side of football, but I still think with the addition of Xavier McKinney, that kind of solves that problem that they have in the secondary. Now, if you just go on the defensive side of football, is Isaiah McDuffie, is he the guy? Is he the starting middle linebacker?
Deal.
I don't know. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. We saw when he filled in last year for Campbell, I thought he played really well. And he knows the system. He was with Halfley in Boston College. So there's some – they kind of know each other and what they like to do. But I still think that there may be a linebacker there drafted pretty high.
Yeah, they definitely need to add there, even though, obviously, if you're playing a 4-3 – you'll have three linebackers on the field on early downs, but that guy's still only going to play like 25% of the snaps. That third linebacker is probably going to come off the field more often than not. I will also say this. You know, if we went through the offense. You talked about the offensive line. So we're talking about left to right, Walker, Jenkins, mm-hmm. Myers, mm-hmm. Ryan, and then Zach Tom, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. And so I feel pretty good about that group. I really do. But, you know, if they drafted, let's say they go at 25 and there's a, you know, this is a really deep draft for offensive linemen. They're talking about eight guys going in the first round from the tackle guard spots. If there's a guy you really like at 25 and Rashid Walker ends up as your new swing tackle backing up both sides, that's a really good problem to have. The dude started 15 games last year.
Right, you got the best of both worlds. And I think if you look at the Packers, they've always drafted linemen that can play multiple spots on the offensive line. So mm-hmm. I think if anyone tells you they know who the Packers are going to draft, they're lying, because I've never been able to guess who they're drafting. But I would say this. I think that would be the best of both worlds if you can bring in some competition for Walker. And still, Walker may beat that guy out because he understands the system. He's been there. He's had a full year on his belt at starting. So I still think that creates good competition on that offensive line, which I think they surely need. I think when you lose Runyon and now you're going to plug in Ryan, but you still have a guy in Sean Ryan who played a lot mm-hmm. for you last year. Over. So, I mean, here's another guy that's had a lot of playing time for you as well.
And you've still got Royce Newman, who's always an option.
Yeah, you got Royce Newman in there. Yeah, you got to have him. I mean, takes up the Don Mikowski, but that's fine.
He's got it's a good look. So one guy, besides Don Mikowski, another one of your favorite people, is Josiah DeGuara.
Yeah, is he still on the team?
He's still available in free agency. No one has picked him up yet. I guess as the president of the Josiah DeGuara fan club, are you surprised by this lack of interest that there has been in him so far?
No, I'm not, but I think you'll see him back as a Green Bay Packer.
Just because you want him back, you've
pretty
got
tough.
The ear of the GM, or how
well,
does
I mean,
that work?
No one can do what Josiah can do. I mean, he's can play like four or five positions for you. I mean, yeah. He can line up at tight end. I mean, he's your fullback. I mean, he's your motion guy. He's your H back. I mean, he can do it all. And you know, he teaches all the young guys. I mean, there's no one that can fill his position. Now you can get him at a bargain basement price, and you know the Packers love a good deal.
Yeah, they could, depending on how much of that $1.45 million they used on A.J. Dillon's contract, they could use some of that still on the fourth-year option on him. Yeah, exactly.
Hey, real quick, were you surprised at the deal that A.J. Dillon got?
I was. I knew of its existence, but the Packers had never used it, and it is, you know, I've done some charity stuff with A.J. Dillon. I've mentioned before Paula coached his wife when she was a youngster at the gym in gymnastics. So I know people get irritated when I say this. I like him. I think he's a good dude. He's been great for the community. Because I say that about Jordan Love a lot. And then there's guys that I don't like, and you know when I don't like them.
We know them. We know who they are.
It pains me to say goodbye to Devondre Campbell, and there's been a few over the years. But be that as it may, look, the deal is one that says basically we don't think you're very valuable, right? And that sucks. That is a crappy feeling to be given. But, you know, I'll give him this, because he could have easily started over somewhere else for slightly more money, you know, a little bit more than what he got, mm-hmm. but probably not a ton more. But somewhere that would have felt like, hey, they really, really want me. Instead, he takes a bargain basement deal on a team that just paid a pretty good penny, at least in 2024 money, to Josh Jacobs, and tried to get Aaron Jones to take a pay cut down to below $4 million a year. He chose, you know, his family, his wife's family is from here. He loves it here. So he kind of swallowed his pride to make a lifestyle choice, even though the team didn't make him feel very valuable. And I'll say this, I respect that he was willing to do that, because I don't know how many people could.
and did it with a smile on his face. Hey, didn't we just see him? Didn't we just see him on stage with Motley Crue here not too long ago?
I did. I believe he was. Is that the concert he was at?
Was that Motley Crue?
I don't. I have not been attending many concerts in the local area lately. But
well, you seem like a Motley Crue kind of guy.
Girls, girls, girls. Yes, that's the theme at my house because I'm surrounded by them, with Paula and Maddie and Sid. Josh DiMaggio tells me it was a Zach Bryan show. Yeah. So there you go. As much as, but you got a Motley Crue reference, which is even better than Zach Bryan, quite frankly. All right, I do want to get to something. Speaking of running backs, that happened yesterday at the NFC coaches breakfast, and this I found very interesting. And I know there are some Packers fans because they're already showing up in my Twitter feed that think this is not a big deal. This is I'm making something out of nothing. But Matt LaFleur talking about how things shifted from Aaron Jones to Josh Jacobs had some very interesting things to say about how that occurred. So I want to get to that coming up next. Okay. We're going to have Tausch tell you about Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. But I got to be honest, Jesse, they were here at the house the other day. And I could easily take Tausch's place in the future now. Like, we sat down, we did the whole deal. I've had other window companies come in, and Pella blows their doors and windows off of them. Like, they are so much more impressive, and you feel so much more confidence than some of these fly-by-night window companies. You know you've got the best, and we're very excited about our process that we've got for our front window. Tausch is even more excited, and you can hear him talk about it as we lead into the commercial break with Gary Ellerson as our cousin sub of the day. It's Wilde and Tausch.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here for Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. If you've been waiting to replace broken windows or doors, or you just want to revitalize your home with a new look, now is the time to get it done. Because from now until March 31st, you can get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. That's right. Pella now and pay later. 3 years later, in fact. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation today at PellaWI.com. Certain restrictions do apply.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Home practice is about to begin. Your daughter's new tap shoes? Loud. Your son's new tuba? Louder. But you got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with $50 overdraft grace zone. So if you lose track of expenses buying some noise-canceling and sanity-saving headphones, we've got your back. You got this with $50 overdraft grace zone from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Cousin Subs was founded in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1972 and has been a member of the Madison community for decades. This year, Cousins has expanded their footprint in the Madison area by opening new locations in Stoughton and Sun Prairie, in addition to existing locations on East Washington Avenue, Monona, and Lodi. Order your favorite subs online or via our app for delivery or pickup. Eat in or grab them to go through our drive-thru for a better sub experience. Cousin Subs, we believe in better.
get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with Design Works, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Listen to Madison Money Guy every Saturday morning at 7 a.m. on 100.5 ESPN and ESPNWisconsin.com.
I like to refer to inflation as the silent killer. It's an invisible risk. It's just the idea that things get more expensive over time. You're going to need milk and eggs when you're in your early 60s and when you're in your early 80s. You're going to get a loaf of bread, and it's going to be more expensive 20 years from now.
Christian Finfrock is the Madison Money Guy. Call him today at 208-1800.
Prize Picks is America's number one fantasy sports app with over 3 million active members. They are the easiest and most exciting way to play daily fantasy sports. All you do, pick more or less on a 2-6 player stat projection and watch the winnings roll in. Whether it's tournament season or the fight for playoff home court, there's no shortage of high-stakes basketball moments this time of year. Prize Picks even offers injury insurance so that your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets hurt. For basketball games, if you have a player who exits the game in the first half and does not return in the second, Prize Picks will have your back and not count that as a loss. Prize Picks is really simple to play. I can make my picks and submit my entry in less than 60 seconds. Prize Picks also offers weekly promotions and special offers for the biggest moments in sports. Download the app today and use code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a deposit match up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
Gary Ellerson is our cousin sub of the day. Cousin subs, we believe in better. Brant tweeted me to remind me, and believe me, I was such a Badger football nerd, at least in my high school and college years. Maybe not when I was four, you know, when Gary was running the football for the Badgers. Okay, maybe not that young. But the only way you could watch the Badgers on TV was WHA in Madison, the PBS affiliate, would run the game tape delayed. And was I a big enough nerd that my freshman year at the University of Wisconsin in 1990, instead of going out with my buddies in Bradley Hall and carousing the streets, although I didn't have a fake ID, so it wasn't like I was going to bars and I didn't like parties. Was I a big enough nerd to sit in my dorm room and rewatch the Badger game that I had attended earlier? A 1-10 Badgers team coached by first-year head coach Barry Alvarez in 1990? Yes, I was.
That was bad. That was bad football.
Not only was it bad, I spent that year in the student section and vowed never to do it again because I had been waiting basically my whole life to be a Badger. Right, I literally was 4 years old when I got my first, I have it here somewhere, my stuffed Bucky Badger. And I always wanted to go to Wisconsin. I was so excited when I got in and I went to the first football game. And then it's profane chants in the student section. It's the rowing where somebody, some stranger's grabbing you in the back and the shoulders. And then that was the era where they were throwing cups at each other. In the student section, I'm like, I don't care that they're terrible. I've been waiting for this my whole life, and I can't watch the game. So after that, I became a reporter, and I went up to the press box and never had to deal with it again. But, yes, I used to watch the games on PBS, and you and Al Toon and the crew, quite a crew back in the day.
Randy Wright. Can't forget about Randy Wright.
No, you can't. And you were Packers teammates too, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And Kenny Stills. I'll tell you this, my signing bonus with the Packers, first thing I did, I bought season tickets Badger season tickets was my first money I spent out of my check. Four. Kenny Stills and I went in together and bought four seats in Section D, row 11, right on the corner, the first four seats.
I appreciate your support of our alma mater, but I have to ask, given what you guys accomplished at Wisconsin, they couldn't just comp you tickets every week that you wanted to go, NFL players that you were?
Yeah, but they could be anywhere. I wanted my seats in my spot. So I've had those seats since, 1984.
Wait, you still have them?
I still have them. 1984.
Wow!
Yep.
Instead of going up to a suite or something else because you're a big deal around campus, you're still in the same seats that you bought as a rookie for the Packers.
Yes. I sit on the 45-yard line right there, behind the bench.
Love in 1984. Hey, so do the people around you
– I should get an award for that.
You should, or at least – or maybe they're just going to come ask you for some contributions to the NIL collective.
That's what they do, yeah.
Do all the same people have the seats around you? Like, do they all know, hey, we're sitting with Badgers royalty, we're sitting with Gary Ellerson and Kenny Stills, or no?
Yeah, so the people in front of me have had those seats as long as I have had them, and the people behind me have had the seats as long as I have had them. Now, we've seen some changes over the years, but for the most part, there's about a group of four or five people have had them since 1984.
That's a great story. It's amazing what you stumble into.
Right. And over the years, I have brought back, guys like Mark Lee, Lynn Dickey. They've all sat in those seats at one point in time or another where we would have a Badger game on a Saturday and a Packer game on a Sunday, and we'd go to the Badger game Saturday and come back and do the Packer game on Sunday. Walter Stanley, all those guys.
Philip Epps. Ed West, have they made the cut?
Ezra Johnson. Paul
was he eating
Kaufman.
A hot dog?
Of course he's eating a hot dog.
So for those of you that are too young to get that reference, let me explain it. We'll get to Matt LaFleur in a minute. So Ezra Johnson is famous for I don't remember the year, but during a preseason game, he was out of the game already, in fairness to Ezra. But he was eating a hot dog on the sideline.
Yep.
And so that's why I asked if he's eating a hot dog while he's sitting with you at the Badger game.
It's a big joke when we go back for reunion, and everybody talks about that. And so Bart Starr asked him, Ezra, why are you eating a hot dog on the sideline? You know what Ezra Johnson's answer was?
No.
Because I was hungry.
Seems like a logical answer.
Makes sense to me.
There are some characters from your era. We should have, for the times that you fill in as our cousin sub of the day, we should have like story time with Gary. Because I bet there are some that would have to be like digital only, I would assume. But there are some characters back then that you could tell stories about. All right, so I do want to get to this LaFleur thing, since you brought this up, I want to ask quickly, because you are, and when we were doing the pregame show during the 2022 season, you would have a different alumni come and spend some time with you and me and Greg Matzik, and you're pretty active in that realm. You were at the Super Bowl with some of your former teammates and some other former Packers, too. Is that... there's two pieces to this question. One, is that something that is important because as time goes by and you're out of the game for a long time, like all players talk about how hard it is, they don't miss necessarily game days as much as they miss the time in the locker room with their teammates. And then the other fact of it is, and I think of this when I think of Mikowski, do you have hope as a former player, and do you guys talk about this when you're together, that maybe the next collective bargaining agreement, since it didn't happen for this one, they do a better job at looking out for the guys who came before them, because you guys, I keep hoping for them to do a better job on the healthcare front for former players, and I'm always let down by that.
Yeah, they need to do a better job in that. But I will say this. I think the Packers, they probably do a better job more than any other NFL team out there that still relates to older players, still have them come back, still do certain functions for them, and have them come back and participate. You're right. I think the hardest thing for guys when they leave and go away is that they miss the locker room. I don't even know if they miss playing, but they miss the guys in the locker room that goes through the same thing. And if you were so to happen to have a wife that you had while you're playing, those wives also a very important part of the camaraderie of people that they met and that they hung out with and really that they grew up with. And not a lot of people can relate to that. So then you fast forward to the NFL Players Association. They also do a great job of bringing all players back to certain events. Now, if you look at the healthcare situation, yeah, that could be a lot better than what it is for a lot of former players. There's a lot of money that they're making. We're seeing right now they're going to play on Christmas, and the NBA doesn't stand a chance. NBA doesn't stand a chance. I mean, they're just blowing the doors off the NBA right now. So we are making a lot of money. I just don't think they're sharing the wealth as well as they could. But I will say this. The Packers, Kathy Dvorak, Nathaniel, those guys up there, I think they've done a great job of keeping guys that want to be around, that want to come and hang out. Mm-hmm. They do a great job of bringing everybody back. Now, I think we have two NFL, we think we have two Packer suites right now. We're all former players. You can go, you can get two tickets, sit in the suite, hang out with your fellow teammates, bring your daughter, bring your wife, bring your kids. And I think they do a great job of that.
And someday they'll invite Aaron Jones to join you in that suite after he's done playing for the Vikings or whomever else he ends up playing with in future years. And for Matt LaFleur, the way that played out came as a bit of a surprise. He talked about that yesterday at the NFL meetings. We'll talk about that coming up next. You can take it to the bank. We won't play take it to the bank today, but you can take it to the bank that he would have liked to have had Aaron Jones still on his football team. I feel fairly confident in that, and that's not a slight on Josh Jacobs. We'll talk about that coming up. Speaking of banks, Associated Bank, it is the official bank of the Packers, and yes, I even snuck them in to my lead in yesterday's Wisconsin State Journal story about Jordan Love, because that's the place to be if you're a Packers fan. Not only do they have Packers checking, where you can get the Packers debit MasterCard, and Packers checking has the 10% off discount at the Packers Pro Shop in-store and online, but you also get the best customer service in the industry. So go to AssociatedBank.com/Packers to find out more. More with Gary Ellerson, our cousin sub of the day. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
UW Credit Union presents the Prep Mania Student Athlete of the Week, supporting local student athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. UW Credit Union is here for every you. Learn more at uwcu.org. Here's Dennis Simra with the UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week.
Our ESPN Madison UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week, Ty Fernholz from Stoughton High School.
How's it going?
Multiple sport athlete. You played football and basketball. This year, concentrating on basketball. You have two brothers, older brothers. What was it like in the driveway playing basketball?
I mean, growing up, we played a lot of games. To be honest with you, I kind of got beat up out there, and I think that has benefited me a lot in high school.
Your coaches say that you have a combination of the brothers. Max was very skilled. So was Luke, but Luke had that kind of feistiness in him and sort of had that chip on your shoulder.
Yeah, just growing up with them, them beating me up, being able to watch them my whole life has helped me a lot.
Are you going to be playing for Michigan Tech next year?
I will, yeah. They were the first people to reach out and the first people to offer me to.
That means a lot during the process, the loyalty.
Yeah, I think just being first means more to me, I guess. And then when I went up there to visit, I just felt like I belonged there than to other schools.
ESPN Madison is on Wisconsin sports. Catch up on anything you missed on the Varsity Podcast on Wisconsin On Demand. Brought to you by Zimbrick Honda, a proud supporter of Wisconsin Badger Athletics. If you're looking to purchase, finance, or service a new or pre-owned Honda, shop local, part of the Madison community since 1973.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Getting 10% back is easy at Fleet Farm. For a limited time only, Fleet Rewards members can earn 10% back on all purchases in-store and online. Spend $50, get $5 back in rewards. No rebates, no coupons, no hassles. Plus, Fleet Rewards membership is free. So if you're not signed up yet, now's the time. Then get shopping to earn 10% back on everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm. Some exclusions apply. Not valid at Ankeny and Waukee, Iowa stores.
You can drive cutting-edge design. 2024 Audis are on the lot and ready for delivery. You can save $7,500 on select Audi EVs with the AFS EV lease bonus. See dealer for details and exclusions. Eligibility is subject to credit approval through Audi Financial Services. Cannot be combined with national customer credit. Offer expires April 1st, 2024. Stop in and test drive today. Check out our website to see our current electric vehicle inventory and our monthly specials. The search for your Audi begins and ends at Zimbrick Audi of Madison, off the Beltline and Rimrock Road. Drive yours today.
Greg Scalzo here for Buck and Honey's. Congratulations to the perennial Best of Madison Award winner by the folks at Madison Magazine. Meet me at Buck and Honey's to celebrate Wisconsin hospitality. Whether you're enjoying the view on the Yahara River in Monona, exploring Wanakee, visiting the OG in Sun Prairie, or checking out the new location in Mount Horeb, you can enjoy the Buck and Honey's experience in a neighborhood near you. Serving lunch and dinner 7 days a week with brunch every Saturday and Sunday. I'll see you at Buck and Honey's.
Join the Madison Money Guy, Christian Finfrock, for retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Get the information you need as you plan for retirement. That's retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Investment advisory services offer the retirement income strategies and SEC registered investment advisor.
From the preps,
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes in a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros,
Beverly launches from three and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
I've got some famous friends you probably never heard of, but back in Rutherford County, our crowd is second to none. You might not know them here in this big city we're in, but when I go back home.
Speaking of distinguished alumni of the Packers and outstanding cousin subs of the day,
cousin subs we believe in better.
You heard him yesterday as our cousin sub. Today, he's got something going on. I don't know what it is exactly, but I know he's on the tailgate tour. We'll have to ask him what he's up to today. He is I'm going to say it, even though Tausch might hear it in the podcast. He's our favorite right tackle. Not even Zach Tom can compete with that. It is Bryan Bulaga on Wilde and Tausch. Bryan, good morning. How are you?
Morning. How are you guys doing?
I'm going to pay a price for that, I'm sure, when the big fella gets back. Hey, what do you got going on today? Because you were nice enough to fill in yesterday. You're nice enough to join us today for a little while. But you're getting ready for the tailgate tour, aren't you?
I am, yeah. I got some media obligations, some phone calls, some things I got to do promoting that and some of the nonprofits that we're going to be visiting and trying to help fundraise for when we're on the road. So I got a couple of those today. I got some stuff out at the property I got to take care of. So Abby and I are going to go out there and do a couple things. I got a couple things going on today.
Well, we appreciate you carving out some time for us. So I knew you were going to join us. So I wanted to bounce this off of both of you guys because I know that I'm going to be accused of having some bias on it. So yesterday, Matt LaFleur is talking at the NFL coaches' breakfast, at the NFC coaches' breakfast, and overcomes Ian Rappaport of the NFL Network. And he asks, I think, what was intended to be an innocuous question, which was,
about the process of signing Josh Jacobs. And Matt LaFleur's reply was, "That's a great question. It kind of caught me off guard, to be honest with you." So Rap Sheet, as he's known on Twitter, follows up, and Matt says, "There were some other things in play, obviously with Aaron Jones. I didn't quite know how everything was going to go, and it just happened really fast on that Monday. They came down," I think he means Russ Ball and Goody, "and when they were allowed to start talking to those guys, it happened really fast, so I don't know the details of that. I'm not involved in those types of conversations, but yeah, we were super excited to get Josh Jacobs." Bryan, I'll start with you. How do you interpret that?
It sounds about right, because I interpret it through my own experience. Obviously, when I left in, you know, back in 2020, and I got my agent called and said that Russ Ball called my agent, said they were sending Ricky Wagner. Shortly after that, I got a call from Matt LaFleur saying he didn't no one really communicated that to him as well. So it doesn't sound completely shocking to me that that's kind of the way it went down. And if we all remember the way this thing, when they restructured the coaching triangle with Russ Ball and the GM and the head coach, you know, they had that little pyramid looking thing or triangle looking thing and how they all communicate with each other. The coach is probably going to be the last one to hear about that based on the GM communicating with Mark Murphy about what they want to do, and then they're going to go do it, and then they're going to tell Coach LaFleur at the end. And obviously the need, we all know the need was for a running back, right? Matt LaFleur, I would imagine, really loves Aaron Jones, likes Aaron Jones, knows what Aaron Jones brings to the team. And the front office saw something a little bit different that they might have, you know, thought was a better opportunity, and they jumped on the opportunity and then let Matt know at the end. And that's kind of what it sounds like, you know, was the communication pattern there. So I'm not shocked, because I can relate to that kind of very similarly when I went through my deal. So it just sounds like that's the way the structure's set up. And, you know, yeah.
So, So, all right. So, Gary, because you played in an era when there was some dysfunction in the front office, obviously, as well, right? And I'm going to get grief from some of our fans, and that's fine. I do believe that this structure is flawed. I will be the first to admit that they won a Super Bowl with Ron Wolf as the GM and Mike Holmgren as the head coach, and there was a clear hierarchy. But those two, even though they definitely disagreed at times, worked well together within that structure. They won a Super Bowl with Ted Thompson and Mike McCarthy, even though they disagreed at times, even though Mike didn't like the fact that he had to be the spokesman for the organization way too often, that worked as well. And then they decided to put the coach and the GM on the same line. And frankly, it feels to me, and I have people in the building who have told me this, that Matt LaFleur does not have the voice that maybe you would think if they're supposedly on the same line of the flow chart organizationally. My question for you, Gary, because I think it is a problem, but I don't want to be biased, is this, like, if the whole idea of the structure being so there would be fewer silos was why they changed the structure, according to Mark Murphy, when the coach isn't being apprised of a major shift in a major position in his offense, is that not at least a little bit problematic, or am I being dramatic?
Well, if they go win a Super Bowl this year, I don't think it's going to matter, right?
Right.
I mean,
sure.
Over the last 20 years, they're the most successful organization in the NFL the way they've done it. And you and I have talked about this all the time. I kind of tease you a little bit about the structure, mm-hmm. and I know you're unhappy about it, but it works. I mean, if you look at the results, it works. Players don't like it, I'm sure, because they're not in on it. I mean, I think, isn't this one of the things that Rodgers was all upset about 4 years ago when he just went scorched earth on everybody and told, you know, he was standing up for the Charles Woodsons and the Cullen Jinxes of the world, people that never knew they were going to come back, never got a phone call. Now we're hearing Bulaga saying the same thing. Josh Sitton, I think, was may be a part of all that situation where they went down doing, I think Badgers were playing LSU at Lambeau Field, and that happened during that game. So it was nuts. Say this to say that. I don't know how they do it. To me, I think Matt LaFleur should be a part of it. So it just feels like Matt LaFleur. And Matt LaFleur goes, well, I guess I got to go coach him up.
Right?
Literally. That's what it is.
I got to go coach him up. That's, I mean, and to me, I think it's wrong. I really do. I think the head coach should be privy to the guys that they're are bringing in. He should at least know or even ask, does this guy work? Or he may not have a say, but I think he should know who's coming in the door. When they get I think, wasn't there 1 year when they brought in a quarterback and Mike McCarthy was up at the podium? Someone asked him about a quarterback that Mike McCarthy didn't even know that was coming in. And he goes, well, I guess that's news to me. And so to me, I think it makes the organization look bad. But it works. We're winning. I'm on both sides here, but it just doesn't, it's not a good look.
Yeah, I mean, and you know what? Like, and the whole thing that Aaron kind of was going on about him, I remember back when he did it, because I remember watching the press conference in the locker room in L.A. when he kind of went on his little tangent about it. And, you know, I understood where he was coming from, and veteran guys that have given X amount to the organization, just a simple phone call. I get all that. And, like, you know, cool. It would have been nice if Goody would have called me. I mean, that is what it is. And, I mean, listen, I've talked to Bryan a bunch since then, and you know, and there's no hard feelings between me and Goody at all. Like I actually enjoy talking to him. I think he's a great guy. I think I look at it from the perspective of when Matt did call me, and he was like, he goes, what, you know, was there something we could have done? And I just was like, Matt, there was never even offer on the table. So there's nothing that you guys could have done because there wasn't a negotiation. And I think that's the thing that we're all kind of agreeing on here, is that the head coach should maybe be looped in on a couple of these things as major transactions get made. Now, obviously, no one's going to argue with the player that they got, right? Like, I don't think anyone's going to sit here and say they're not excited about the player. That's not the issue. I think just the issue is, you know, when you bring in, you know, this offense at the heart of it, and Matt LaFleur's offense is a run – first offense. That is what it is at the heart of it. And when you bring in, or not even bring in, when you let go of an Aaron Jones and bring in someone without communicating that to the head coach, it does make you kind of look at it and go, you know, what is being told? Like, what is the line of communication between the head coach and the GM and the owner? And we know the structure, but could that be cleaned up? I mean, I think we all look at that and agree that that should be cleaned up. Gary, as you said, they win, and it works, and we all understand that, and that's great. But I just look at it because obviously I know Matt personally, and then when he gets asked a question like that and that's the answer he gives, it kind of makes you go, oof, man, like that's you know, it just doesn't sound right. You know what I mean? Because I can assure you, if you walk over to the AFC breakfast, Andy Reid knows absolutely everything that is going on with players in, players out. I can assure you, even now, where I came from in L.A., Harbaugh knows every player in and out. There's no line of communication that's not being given to the head coach. So that's the only thing I look at it as. And you know, we understand Green Bay, they do things different than other teams just because they don't have an owner and this and that. But if it's me, I'm looking to try to loop in the head coach as much as possible about major decisions being made. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, and look, in fairness, there are some advantages too, right? Because let's say a guy's going through a contract dispute. The coach is able to say, hey, I'm on your side, man, right? Like, he's got that's a player that's important to his locker room, whatever. That gives him some plausible deniability, right? So that's not a bad thing. But when he publicly admits, and I'm not getting after LaFleur here for saying this, I want the truth, and this is what the truth is. It's not a good look, as Gary said. Now, I would also add this, and Bryan, you made a good point about you and Goody's relationship. And I had a couple people coming at me yesterday on social media. I hate this organization. I hate the general manager. Goody and I have a really good working relationship. I like Goody the guy. At times, I do criticize him. And you can probably say that I play the greatest hits of my issues with him on a regular basis. The Devontae Adams trade, the way they treated Jordy, the way they treat players on their way out the door. This is another one that adds on. But I would argue to those that think I'm too critical of him or that I hate him, which is just fundamentally not true. Like, we send Christmas cards to each other, for crying out loud. Like, I don't hate Bryan Gutekunst. What I do think is it's my job to, if I think he did something that I don't agree with and I think is a bad look, it's for me to say that it's not a good look. And that's what I would say in some of these instances, including the Aaron Jones departure and the way the head coach was not aware of this. But I don't hate Bryan Gutekunst. And by the way, if these are the only greatest hits that I play to criticize him, that's a pretty good sign that he hasn't done that much that deserves criticism. Because if I was covering another team with a really crappy GM, we'd be spending every show talking about what an idiot move this was, and that was, and that was. And that's not the case. He is a very good GM. I don't think he's great with people, especially with people in the building. And I think there are people in the building that would back me up on that. And it wasn't just Aaron Rodgers. And we all have things we can improve on. And I hope that maybe he's improved in that department from the days that, you know, you found out they were signing Ricky Wagner and that was it for you as a Green Bay Packer. Doesn't mean you hold a grudge against him, but there's better ways to do it. That's all.
But if you go back, though, but Ted Thompson, was he a great people person? I don't think he was. I mean, these guys are from the same people. I mean, maybe he learned that from them. Just to go back even further, though, but the doom of Mike Sherman was the GM head coach, where then I think some of the relationships that he had with players soured.
No
and
doubt.
And that's when the Packers decided to go back and change that again because Mike Sherman couldn't do both. And so now we are where we are again, and now we're still having a situation with your head coach not being privy to the guys that you brought in. I just think that I'm with Bryan. They do need to clean that up a little bit. But we've seen in Packer history that how bad Forrest Gregg, Tom Brotts, I mean, you can go on and on and on, how bad the situation was at certain times in Packer history.
Yeah, and in fairness, I hold people to very difficult standards. The team president I hold to Bob Harlan's standard, and the general manager, no matter who it is, I hold to the Ron Wolf standard. Who, look, Ron Wolf could be a cantankerous fella, but he was a straight shooter with his players. And there was no player ever left without a meeting with him first. And that is something that probably needs to be improved upon. I would also add this. With Ted, early in his tenure, he was a little more like Ron in terms of dealing with players. I think you're right. I think as time went on, and maybe his health factored into this, he was not as communicative with players. There were other issues that I know Brian's never going to get into on the radio about some of the things that were handled inside the building back then. So I get it. But that doesn't mean that now the next guy can't just be like Ted. Like, he needs to be better at that. I think that's a valid criticism. Again, I don't think I criticize him much. Bryan, before we let you get ready for all of your tailgate tour plans, we had the news of the kickoff changes come into play yesterday while you were on the show. I'm going to ask Gary, because I'm guessing the kickoff was a very different experience for him back when he was a player in his era. I am curious, though, we didn't get to talk a lot about Keyshawn Nixon. And given how much you watch tape, not just of the offensive line, it sounds to me, forget the kickoff aspect of him, Matt LaFleur and Goody both talked about how much Halfley really likes Keyshawn Nixon and what he can do in his defense. Did you see that in Joe Barry's defense, and are you intrigued at how excited they are to have Keyshawn Nixon back as a defensive player? Because you and I didn't get to that yesterday.
Yeah, I mean, I think you look at the new structure of what what Halfley's bringing in compared to what Joe Barry did. I mean, we're talking night and day differences of the structure of this defense and what's being asked of DBs. And I thought last year Nixon on defense, and this is not a knock on him. I think it's kind of just the way the defense was. There were guys out there in the secondary that at times didn't seem like they knew what their responsibility was. And they were very – and that was very clear in the Giants game when they said communication wasn't getting, you know, sent across the field on what coverages they're supposed to be running and things of that nature. When it's a two-minute drill and you don't know what coverage you're supposed to be in, that's a problem, right? So
yes.
I feel like with this structured defense, yes, he wants to be aggressive with his corners and with his nickel guys and the safeties, which I think is really good for a guy like Nixon, because I think he's an aggressive guy by nature. He is a full-time special teams guy, and those guys that return kicks and cover kicks and do things like that are aggressive by nature. That's what that's what they're kind of cut to do. So I think he will be a good fit. How they deploy him, whether it's in the slot, whether he moves – depending on what they do in the draft, if he's a guy that they like to move in and out of the safety position, I don't think he's a corner at heart. I don't think that's his best role, because the way this defense is going to be played, like I've told you before, Jason, I like – all these guys come from that cover three mindset of Pete Carroll and that Seahawks defense. The corners are butts to the sideline, eyes on the quarterback, backpedaling, and jump routes. And then they show man, drop into cover three, and they're aggressive. I'm not sure that's Nixon's thing out at corner, but at the slot position, I can certainly see him fitting in nicely there. But again, it's hard to, like, put all my eggs in that basket when we didn't really just see it on tape last year. There's just not much evidence of that. So clearly there's something that they see that they really like, or Halfley really likes. But I think this will all be dependent on where they deploy him based on what they do in the draft, right? Like, if we talked about Cooper DeJean or any safeties that are coming out, like if you drafted DeJean, you're probably going to play him at safety, and then you're checking that box for Nixon to be in the slot, which is, I think, a really good position for him. He could be aggressive, get his hands on guys, disrupt route timing and things like that. So there's a role for him, but just based on what they do in the draft and what guys they bring in to fill in that secondary where he's gonna slot in.
Brian's right. I think when you watch the Packers secondary last year, and it, for those people that can see me, it was always the shrug emoji.
Yep.
And when you're, this is why you need to watch the video.
Every game, shrug emoji. So when you got the shrug emoji going, you've got a problem. It seems like for the last 10 years, the Packers secondary, all of it, get the shrug emoji. So communication is the key back there. Hopefully Xavier McKinney, hopefully they bring him in. He can clear up some of that stuff, and all these guys can be on the same page.
Bryan, we'll let you get ready for the bus tour. I think we have a special surprise for when that departs in a couple of weeks.
Quick question
yeah?
to Bryan.
Sure.
Who's all on the bus tour, Bryan? Who's there?
So it'll be myself, Kenny Clark, Elton Jenkins, Alex Green, remember a running back when I was there early on, and then Mike Daniels, who is always a great personality to have on a bus for five straight days. So, it's always good to be on a bus with Mike Daniels for 5 days. So, yeah, that's what we got going on.
Good luck to you, sir. There's some intensity there. He was on with us a couple weeks ago. He is a joy. That, all kidding aside, he's a fun guy, and we appreciate you. We will see you next week. Maybe Tausch will be back to talk with you, and I'll talk to you at some point on the Homer Hour as well. Thanks, Bryan.
All right, guys, take care.
That is our friend Bryan Bulaga as he gets ready. I think the tailgate tour leaves on like April 9th or 10th-ish, but it is coming through Sun Prairie, and I think we're going to be there as well. All right, more with Gary Ellerson as our cousin sub of the day. Cousin subs, we believe in better. Stick around. It's Wilde and Tausch.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
Prize Picks is America's number one fantasy sports app with over 3 million active members. They are the easiest and most exciting way to play daily fantasy sports. All you do, pick more or less on a 2-6 player stat projection and watch the winnings roll in. Whether it's tournament season or the fight for playoff home court, there's no shortage of high-stakes basketball moments this time of year. Prize Picks even offers injury insurance so that your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets hurt. For basketball games, if you have a player who exits the game in the first half and does not return in the second, Prize Picks will have your back and not count that as a loss. Prize Picks is really simple to play. I can make my picks and submit my entry in less than 60 seconds. Prize Picks also offers weekly promotions and special offers for the biggest moments in sports. Download the app today and use code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a deposit match up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
You, rah, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by your Badgerland Chevy dealers, proud supporters of Badger Athletics. Go to BadgerlandChevy.com. As the Wisconsin men's basketball season comes to an end, more news of players potentially headed out the Kohl Center door. Star guard A.J. Storr has announced he will pursue the NBA draft while maintaining his college eligibility. That means Storr will likely participate in workouts and a combine for NBA teams without hiring an agent, and if he so chooses, can return to Wisconsin next season. During his only season in Madison, A.J. Storr led the team, averaging over 16 points per game.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
Jim Rutledge here to talk to you about North and South Seafood and Smokehouse, the official barbecue joint of Rutledge and Hamilton, and the official barbecue joint of the Rutledge household. We love going to all three of their locations, whether it's in DeForest, Madison, or in Verona. We get the same great service and food every time we go, no matter the location. Even better, when we have parties, cookouts, or anything in between, I don't have to spend all my time over the grill. Instead, I give a call to the folks at North and South Seafood and Smokehouse. So hurry in to North and South Seafood and Smokehouse, the official barbecue joint of Rutledge and Hamilton, and the official barbecue joint of the Rutledge household.
You can't miss a moment with Greeny.
Three teams in the NFC South spent $250 million guaranteed dollars on these three quarterbacks who have played 28 seasons and won three playoff games. Kirk Cousins has been involved in more NFL games that ended in a tie than he has playoff wins. A tie happens like once every three NFL seasons. They have the playoffs every year.
Greeny, weekdays noon to 2 on 100.5 ESPN.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit celebrationsentertainment.com. That's celebrationsentertainment.com.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
Bryan, Bulaga, always great to catch up with him. He's doing double duty this week, filling in for Tausch as a cousin sub yesterday and then joining us today. All right, Gary, real quick before we get to the 10 o'clock hour, we
had a little fun at Mike Daniels' expense. The idea of being on a bus for 5 days with him. Your teammate, I'm going to put you on the spot, your teammates from your time that you would not, or maybe you would really, like to be on a bus for 5 days with.
One teammate?
You can pick as many as you want. It's your bus.
It's my bus. Well, you've got to have Lynn Dickey on the bus.
I love him. He's great.
He's got to be there. And then you got to have James Lofton on the bus. You just got to have him. And you got to have Ron Hallstrom on the bus.
Really? Another old 65.
You got to have Ron Hallstrom on the bus. And then you got to have Greg Cook and Ron Hallstrom kind of go together.
Oh, boy, that's trouble.
Is that trouble? And then for myself, you have to have the calming influence of all of that along with James Lofton. You got to have Gary Ellis on the bus.
Is he the calming influence?
Yes. Because he kind of brings everybody together. James is kind of a smart guy. And then you got to have Paul Kaufman and Lynn Dickey because they kind of pair off on each other. So you got to pair guys up to calm one guy down and then to make sure, but still enough guys to have fun.
Mm-hmm.
Who wouldn't be on the bus with me because no one could control him would be Charles Martin.
R.I.P. Right? Yes, he's no longer with us?
Yes, he's no longer with us. Could not have him on the bus.
Could we have him on the bus?
Martin story? You hear first Charles Martin story?
I love Charles Martin stories. Yeah, we've got time.
So we're at a local watering hole in Green Bay. And so we go to the same place all the time. I mean, Green Bay was small back then, and, you know. And so everybody knows all the Packer players. I don't think Packer players hang out as much as they used to in Green Bay anymore.
Probably fair.
These guys see them. Right. So we go to this local watering hole, and everybody knows we're there. And Charles Martin liked to line up all his beers, all the empties, bottles. And he would line them up on the bar. And so there could be about, I don't know, 25 to 30 empty bottles on the bar, all lined up.
Boy.
He liked to look at them, blah, 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 blah. And the bartender, we always have the same bartender all the time. Well, this particular night, there was a different bartender. So Charles gets up to go to the bathroom, fine, comes back. The bartender, as well as he should, clean out all the bottles, gone. Charles proceeded to go across the bar to grab the bartender and strangle him.
Oh, no.
And then we all had to grab Charles, and Charles is screaming, he threw away my bottles, he threw away my bottles. And we were saying, Charles, it's his first, he doesn't know the Charles Martin rule. He's just some kid from Green Bay Southwest trying to earn a little money. Relax. So we had to get Charles out of the bar. Next thing we know, here comes the cops. We're going one way, and the cops are going the other way. We get Charles out of the bar. Rest is history.
Why am I not surprised, though, that Charles Martin, who, of course, is well known for his body slam of Jim McMahon, would have maybe overreacted to his bottles being taken away from him. Those are the kind of stories we get when we've got Gary. Gary Ellerson is our cousin sub of the day. We'll kick off the 10 o'clock hour in 2 minutes. So stick around. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here for my friends at Kohler Services. If you need a bath or shower remodel, turn to Kohler Services. Family owned for 150 years. Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. This month only, get $1,000 off your Luxtone shower and pay nothing until 2025. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional installation always included. Again, that's KohlerServicesWI.com.
This is Derek Engler. You're listening to a Good Karma Brands radio station, 100.5 ESPN WTLX Monona, Madison.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison, and streamers everywhere. I'm Jesse Nelson, Sports Center, brought to you by Goodman's Jewelers, the diamond store of Madison for generations. Check them out, 220 State Street, and online at goodmansjewelers.com. Extra basketball last night at Fiserv Forum did not go the way of the Milwaukee Bucks. 128-124, the LeBron-less Los Angeles Lakers defeat the Bucks in double overtime of a nationally televised game on TNT. The Bucks fall despite Giannis getting a triple-double, 29 points, 21 rebounds, 11 assists in the double OT performance last night. Damian Lillard had 27 for Milwaukee. Next up, the Bucks visit the New Orleans Pelicans Thursday night. Listen to it right here on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN. College basketball. Number 2 seed Marquette in the South Region preparing for the Sweet 16. They take on 11 seed North Carolina State Friday night. Tip time set for 6:09. Don't be a minute too late. Listen to the game on our sister station, 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee. Head coach Shaka Smart appeared this morning on Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio. If you missed the conversation, you can find it on ESPNWisconsin.com.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
That we can all agree on is that Jordan Love was pretty darn good last year, at least during the second half of the season, and it bodes well for what he could be in 2024. We spent some time earlier in the week talking about what the contract might look like. We'll ask Gary his thoughts on that coming up, but I want you to hear what Mark Murphy, he was not at the WIAA Girls State High School basketball tournament saying this. Instead, he said,
"We got to get the Chippewa Falls."
That's not what he said either, but he might be saying that on the bus tour. He did say that he was really impressed with Jordan Love. Here's Mark Murphy yesterday at the NFL meetings in Orlando.
"I'm pretty damn good. No, I'm really, really happy for, you know, obviously Jordan, the way he played, and you know, not only his, the level that he played at, especially as the season got on, he just seemed to get more and more confident. But his leadership, you know, we saw that, you know, throughout the off season and certainly during the season. So really, really pleased with the way he's played. And I do think the future is really bright."
Yeah, I think we all agree with Mark on that. My question, Gary, as you've kind of watched this unfold, is there any, and I'm not saying it should be a big concern by any stretch of the imagination, but the one thing that I have been saying is that I do think that defensive coordinators with 17 games of film on Jordan Love are going to have a better idea of how to defend him. And then Jordan Love, who I think is really good, will figure out the counter move to that. But I think there's going to be some bumps in the road. I don't think he's going to play the way he played for the 9-game stretch and the season in which he threw 18 touchdowns and only one interception. I think he's going to have some bad games, which I don't think is that harsh of a criticism for a guy that I think looks pretty darn good. What do you say?
Well, I think it's all on Matt LaFleur as well, because I think whether Matt LaFleur wants to admit it or not, we finally saw Matt LaFleur's offense, and we finally saw how Matt was able to scheme certain guys open that they knew guys were going to be open. So we finally saw all that. So all the defensive coordinators right now are looking at the Packers probably last 6-7 games and saying this is what we've got to stop. Now it's up to Matt LaFleur to have a counter to what these defensive coordinators are doing to him. Jordan Love, rightly so, now got to have a counter to what they are going to take away. I think the biggest thing now, though, for this offense and the unknown is Josh Jacobs. What does he bring to this offense that's going to be different than what Aaron Jones did? Because they're not the same running back. I mean, can he catch the football out of the backfield? I mean, I saw him a couple years ago when he led the league in rushing, and he's a bruiser, hard-nosed guy. But I saw him break some runs, but last year I think he only rushed for like 800 yards, so didn't really have a great year. I mean, here's another guy I think that has a lot of miles on him, but most certainly I think will benefit from this offense, but still a unknown factor within this offense. And how does Matt LaFleur get him in his offense and use? Because I think what Matt has been able to do is find out what these guys can do best. And so it'll be exciting to see how he put Josh Jacobs in his offense and how he's used.
Yeah, I'm really eager. Matt LaFleur made a comment yesterday about seeing some film of Josh Jacobs running some choice routes. That is something that Aaron Jones did extremely well. I don't know if there's a ton of film, and talking to a few other people that have watched much more of Josh Jacobs than I had. I like Josh Jacobs as a runner. I like his style. Yeah. I think he was a really good player for the Raiders. I think Antonio Pierce feeling the same way about losing Josh Jacobs as Matt LaFleur feels about losing Aaron Jones tells you that the Packers should feel good that they got Josh Jacobs. Just because we think, you know, they could have still used Aaron Jones doesn't mean that Josh Jacobs isn't a great acquisition. But another thing that Matt LaFleur talked about yesterday was Jordan Love's development. Here is Matt LaFleur talking about his quarterback.
We've been in contact, you know, just checking in, just seeing how he's doing with a lot of our players, but in particular him. And, you know, he went out west to California. I know he's working out there. But, yeah, I think he is excited to get back to work, and he's putting in that work right now as we speak.
I think what's interesting, Gary, is that, and we won't hear it today, but maybe you and Jesse can talk about it because you got two full days together coming up, is the conversation that he had yesterday, LaFleur talking about how they didn't really know what they had offensively going into last season with all the young guys at receiver and tight end and a first-year starting quarterback. And now when he's having these conversations that he mentioned with Love, they have ideas that they can build off of what they did last year. To me, that's going to be a game changer for both the coach slash play caller and for the quarterback.
Yeah, because it was evolving the whole time. I mean, player after player after player. I mean, you had to figure out what was Josiah DeGuara's role in this offense last. Okay, maybe not. But you still had a lot of young players, Dontavian Wicks, right? Romeo Doubs. A lot of these guys had their moments within this offense. Tucker Kraft, the only reason why he got more play because Musgrave went down, then Musgrave came back. So they have a lot of talent they can do a lot of different things with. I think in each game, it will be a different guy. I just think, to me, the sky's the limit with this team, and they're only getting better. Then I think you ask Josh Jacobs to this mix and what they can do with him. Now, Aaron Jones, we knew that they can slide him out and put him in a slot. Can Josh Jacobs do those types of things in the passing game? I'm not exactly sure, but they still have a lot of guys within this offense that they can move around, get the matchups that they really need. Jaden Reed is another guy. I think Jaden Reed's a guy that you can put in the backfield, you put him in a slot, motion guy. I mean, he seems to be the guy that really holds this team down from an offensive standpoint.
We'll talk more about what was discussed yesterday, including Mark Murphy, mentioning what I thought was really interesting, and that's that he thinks Matt LaFleur and Goody are doing a great job. Yeah, hard to argue with that position.
But are they talking to each other?
Right, even when they're not keeping each other in the loop. We'll talk about that coming up. I want to remind you, Gerbil offices, one call, that's all. I was texting with David. He was wearing a bright red sport coat last night during the Bucks game, the double overtime loss to the Lakers. I saw him on the sideline or in the stands, and I thought that is one bright red coat. But hey, he stands out. You know that. And that means that if you need his help and his firm's help because you've been injured, that he knows what he's doing because he knows how to get the job done. Check out Gruber-Law.com. That's Gruber-Law.com. Or make that one call, that's all. 414-276-6666. 414-276-6666. More with Gary Ellerson, our cousin sub of the day. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Mark Tauscher here for Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie, the name you can trust. Well, it's the time of the year when everybody is thinking about travel. Whether you're still finalizing details for a spring getaway or you're already on to thinking about where you'll be heading for a summer road trip, don't let vehicle maintenance be what slows you down. Make sure your vehicle is in its best shape possible every time you're getting ready to hit the road by stopping in to see the amazing service team at Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie. Routine maintenance is critical for keeping your vehicle in the best shape possible. Oil changes, tire rotations, tune-ups, and so much more. Get it checked out before you hit the road so you're not stranded when you're away from home. And if you're in the market for a vehicle upgrade, check out Zimbrick Chevy's new and used vehicle inventory. You can start your search by logging on to ZimbrickChevrolet.com. Stop into Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie and discover this great automotive team I've been telling you about for years. Consistently recognized as a best of Madison operation, Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie, the name you can trust.
The host might be irrelevant, but the conversations aren't.
So to only have two wins in the NCAA tournament since they made the Sweet 16 in 2017, it's just unacceptable for a program that should be nationally recognized.
Mr. Irrelevant with Alex Strofe.
I was a betting man. I would guess Greg Gardner the head coach next season. It's got to be a big tournament run or bust next year.
Mr. Irrelevant with Alex Strofe. Live on ESPN Madison's YouTube every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And available wherever you get your podcasts.
LabCorp Clinical Trials is changing to a new name, Fortrea. While the name may be different, Fortrea combines decades of great experience and professionalism with new opportunities for clinical trial participation. It's more than a mission and more than a new name. Fortrea is dedicated to moving healthcare forward. To learn more about the future of healthcare and upcoming clinical trials, visit us at FortreaClinicalTrials.com. That's F-O-R-T-R-E-A ClinicalTrials.com.
Mark your calendars and get ready for game day at the 5th Annual Easter Seals Wisconsin Celebrity Basketball Experience, presented by Affiliated Dentists. Former UW athletes hit the hardwood on April 13th at Madison College to support children and adults with disabilities. Tip-off is at 3 p.m. And for some pregame action, be sure to register your kids grades 3 through 8 at the Shot Doctor Skills Academy from 1 to 2:30 with former UW men's basketball assistant coach Gary Close. All abilities welcome to register. Visit easterseals.com/gameday for more details.
Good Karma Brands is proud to be an equal opportunity employer. Our policy is to provide equal opportunity employment, development, and advancement to all current and potential teammates. If you are an organization that maintains a job bank, provides employment information, or gives job referrals, you may request to be placed on the station's mailing list for future career opportunities. To learn more about careers at Good Karma Brands, please email careers@goodkarmabrands.com.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
I say, hey, I'll be gone today, but I'll be back from around the way. It seems like everywhere I go, the more I see, the less I know. But I know one thing, that I love you.
So I mentioned this earlier. And there are a few things that are known to irritate me. And one of them is to suggest that I hate Goody or I hate the Packers, I hate the administration. Mark Murphy and I are not pals. I don't have the same rapport or frankly the same respect that I have for Bob Harlan. I just don't. I think Bob Harlan did things the right way. I think there's been some things during the Mark Murphy era that I didn't agree with. I don't hate him. I don't strongly dislike him. We don't have the same relationship.
Can we Goody talk more about your Christmas cards you send to Goody? I feel like that was glanced over there.
His family is on our Christmas card list there, and we're on there. So I'm not like, and again, if there's something that I think he deserves criticism for, I criticize him for it, right? Well, you've heard me do it, whether it was Sadie also very critical of Goody. Whether it was the Davante Adams trade, which I still thought was a mistake, whether it was the fact that he came out and said that Aaron Jones was absolutely expected to be back and then wasn't, like there are some missteps that he's had that it's my job to be critical of him. But the bottom line is he's done a very good job. Hasn't won a Super Bowl on his watch.
Yes.
But has negotiated some challenging steps, including the situation with the starting quarterback, that was not easy to do. And I think we've seen that Aaron Rodgers, in years that have followed or the year that has followed, probably was not the easiest guy to work with at times. So that said, I don't disagree with what Mark Murphy says right here, which is that they should feel really good about the job that the general manager, the head coach, and the chief contract negotiator have done with this team. Here's Mark Murphy.
If you had told me a year ago, we'd be here, in the playoffs. Should have. I mean, we didn't. We lost the 49ers, but, I mean, we were in that position. I can't say enough good things about both Matt and Bryan. And Russ Ball is a key part of that as well. But the way Matt and Bryan work together, it's really bodes well ahead for the future.
Yeah, Matt LaFleur is a good football coach, and Goody's a good personnel guy. I don't know about how they work together, as we established earlier in the show, but they both do their jobs at a high level, Gary, and that's one of the reasons, along with Jordan Love playing damn well, that they're in the position they're in.
No, they are. And when you're trying to compare Bob Harlan to Mark Murphy, I don't think there is no real comparison there. I mean, but I think Mark has done an incredible job at advancing the Green Bay Packers and
the business
where they are, the business
no
side
doubt.
Of it. You have to
totally
give them
agree.
All the credit. You walk into Lambeau Field and in around there now, that's Mark Murphy's baby. And so he's done a great job of keeping us and keeping that thing generating money. We just don't like or understand the structure that has taken place and the way it has splintered out, so to speak. But it's under Mark's guidance. It seemed to be working. I still think that it's a little disjointed. I still think the right and the left hand should be knowing what's going on, and that's not happening. My first dealings with Bob Harlan in Green Bay was one of this. Kenny Stills and I take a limousine to Madison to a function. And we got a limousine, and the limousine company was from Green Bay. We got a limousine. The guy goes back to Green Bay. Then he comes back two days later, pick Kenny and I up, blah, blah, blah. And so we leave, and we never paid the guy. And a week later, Bob Harlan calls Kenny Stills and I up to his office. First dealing with Bob. Had never seen him before. We were rookies. Calls us up to his office. So we walk into the office. Bob is standing there. And Bob says, hey, this guy just called me, the owner of the limousine company in Green Bay, said that you guys took a limousine to Madison, and then he came and picked you up 2 days later and dropped you back off here in Green Bay. Is that true? And we both said, yes, sir, we did. And Bob said, well, did you pay him? And we said, no, sir, we didn't pay him. He says, why? I says, Bob, we never signed a contract. He says, well, did you shake his hand? I go, yeah, we shook his hand. He goes, a handshake deal is binding. Pay the man. That was Bob Harlan, right?
Uh-huh.
Man of the people. I mean, so when you – Bob operated – I think Bob was more for the people, and that's why everybody was talking about the stories that he always answered his phone I don't know if Mark does that, but
he does not.
Was Bob in a nutshell. And but I would say Mark has done a great job of moving the franchise into today's time.
The business aspect, I would give him no criticism whatsoever for at
all. Right.
They are not a mom and pop organization. I get all that. Again, and maybe it's just that I believe that you can have hard conversations with people that are difficult, but they can also be done in a way that is respectful. Like, Mike McCarthy will never forgive him for the way he handled his dismissal. A half hour after a game, straight from the podium, had to make special arrangements to come back and be able to talk to his team the next day. I mean, you let him go home, you have him come in the next morning, you inform him that you're relieving him of his duties, you give him the opportunity to address the team, and then your interim coach takes over. Those are the types of things that do matter, because you said Bob Harlan, a man of the people.
Yes.
I don't think there's many people that would argue that Bob Harlan ever treated them poorly. And so I think, and you're telling me that Bob Harlan never had any difficult conversations with anybody? No, he definitely did, including telling two rookie knuckleheads who played for the Badgers, hey, you got to pay the limousine guy, right?
Pay the guy.
So you can have those conversations and do it in a way that is I just think respectful, and I know Mike McCarthy very well, and Mike McCarthy is not perfect, but he deserved, and I'm not saying he didn't deserve to be fired. I personally would have let him finish the season, cuz you were going nowhere anyway, and it was BS to argue that you were giving Joe Philbin an opportunity to potentially earn the job. That was never it. He was never going to get the job. And Joe Philbin knew that. But nevertheless, I'm not saying he didn't deserve to be fired. I'm saying he deserved to be fired better, if that makes sense.
Well, I think what was Mike's really undoing, I believe in that press conference, maybe you can remember this, Jason, I think somewhere in that press conference after the game, or I think they asked Mike a question about what can he do to make it better. I think Mike says, I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do. And I think at that point when he said that, I don't know, that like he was lost for words, how to make this team better, I think didn't sit well with Mark Murphy.
Well, and that was because their roster was starting to come apart at the seams. And that was Goody's first year. And I don't blame Goody for that. You've heard me say this many times. I blame myself for not being more journalistic about Ted's struggles late in his time as the GM, because that definitely affected
that. Who was going to do that?
Right. And again, I allowed my affinity for...
We all knew that. You weren't the only one.
I know.
You weren't
but
the only one.
In my job, I am supposed to be able to put personal feelings aside, and the question of whether it's a private matter or not, it's a publicly owned team. And so I have always... No. From a moral perspective, I always felt like I did right by Ted, and that others of us did. From a journalism perspective, that's probably open to debate. But the bottom line is that team was falling apart. Goody, it was his first year as the GM. You know what he did the following offseason? He brought in four free agents for the first team that Matt LaFleur coached, with the two Smith brothers, Adrian Amos and Billy Turner, and they started trending the other direction. So I'm not defending Mike McCarthy. He deserved, it was time to move on. But there was a way to do it, and the way they did it was not the right way. All right, we need to get to Homer and move on to him as he joins us every Wednesday. You guys do your little program together every Friday, right? You're on the Homer Hour. That's your gig with him?
Yeah, we got a little show that we do. I mean, it's not as big as the Wilde and Tausch deal. I mean, I get it. So we got a little show that we do.
Well, that's for being honest, that's a pretty high standard
What kind of function did you take a limo to from Green Bay to Madison that took 2 days before you went home? Like, that sounds like a bachelor party is what that sounds like to me.
Well, I mean, it was a day on State Street. You got to hit them all. You got to hit the KK. You got to get them all in, but it takes 2 days.
A function. Yeah, it was a bar crawl with all our college buddies. Take the limo.
Yeah, take the limo. Drop us off. got back
and then forget to pay him. Homer joins us next.
I don't know what we forgot, but
I appreciate your honesty. More next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Gold medalist Matt Hamilton, judgmental Jim Rutledge, Rutledge and Hamilton.
So you're not special.
Yeah,
it's
so
special.
You're picking on some people.
No. You're always the bridesmaid. You are so close to getting married over and over again, then you get dumped at the altar.
You've never had
years.
A guy. Jim, if we want to play this game, we can play this game.
Rutledge and Hamilton with Jim Rutledge and Matt Hamilton. Presented by Coors Light. Weekdays 4 to 6 on 100.5 ESPN. Also brought to you by J&K Security Solutions.
Join the Madison Money Guy, Christian Finfrock, for retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Get the information you need as you plan for retirement. That's retirement income strategies Saturday and Sunday mornings at 7. Investment advisory services offer the retirement income strategies and SEC registered investment advisor.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Cousin Subs was founded in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1972 and has been a member of the Madison community for decades. This year, Cousins has expanded their footprint in the Madison area by opening new locations in Stoughton and Sun Prairie, in addition to existing locations on East Washington Avenue, Monona, and Lodi. Order your favorite subs online or via our app for delivery or pickup. Eat in or grab them to go through our drive-thru for a better sub experience. Cousin Subs, we believe in better.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
I've been here for about 3 years, been a team lead since 3 months. I love the company. It's a fun place to work. It always keeps you busy every single day. Right off the bat, I told them I wanted a career here. Sure enough, after 3 months, I got promoted. You just got to make sure that you have the ambition to get there. I can one day see my kid and say, hey, look, I built that trailer. My name is Gabriel, and I am incredibly proud to be part of Stoughton Trailers.
Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
From the preps.
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros.
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Making love, I'm starting the schoolyard fight.
You know what that music means? Duke Tomato and the All-Star Frogs. It means it's time to talk to Homer. You hear him every weekday on the Homer Hour with a cavalcade of stars, including Gary Ellerson and Bryan Bulaga, John Anderson. I join him a couple times a week, although I do miss our daily chats that we used to have. You also hear him on the Marquette Men's Basketball Radio Network, including the Varsity app, which is where I listen to him on the call of Marquette's win over Colorado, which was good stuff. I paired it up with the TV. Good stuff. And, of course, you can also find him on YouTube. God Talk, My Faith with Homer and Pip. It is Steve the Homer. True Homer, good morning. How are you?
I'm awesome because Gary nailed it. Gary, perfect. We do a little show. We have a little show.
We got a little show.
And, in fact, Gary is going to be on the little show on Thursday because Tony Smith can only do a couple minutes because he's going to be in Dallas. And so Gary's going to help fill in for the last, 45 minutes of the little show on Thursday. That should be the new name of it. Not the home hour, but the little show. What do you think, Gary? Little show with Gary Ellison.
Yeah.
Nice.
Hey, you know what?
I will go.
Do you see
if they agree?
Do that. Do you get a Christmas card from Jason Wilde, though? I was just wondering.
Do I?
Yeah.
I do, but I think that's because I send him the true family letter. If I didn't. I think anytime someone sends you a Christmas card, you're just an evil person if you don't send them one back.
Is that what happened
with Goody?
No, that's not. These are not. None of these things are true. First of all,
with that premise?
I've had Goody's address from long before he was the general manager. This is something that dates back to his time as a scout. Also, I have been sending Homer our family Christmas card for many years, not because I got an advanced copy of the letter this year, which I felt very special by receiving electronically. We send Christmas cards to people that we care about and that we have great relationships
with. If someone was not on your list and they sent you a card, don't you feel obligated to send them one?
It's a good question.
It's not a good question. It's an easy question.
No, it's a good question. It's more complicated than you think because here's the deal. So we do Shutterfly, and as you saw, I put a lot of work into that. Like Gary, maybe you'll be on the list this year now that we've worked together a lot more. It's a lot. Almost as much.
Now you have to send one more out.
Right, but when we place the order, we order a finite amount, and once we're out, we're out. So we don't have.
Hold on. this is just so weak.
When we're out, we're out.
Say you order 500. No, you always order 50 extra.
I think we order 225.
Okay.
And
how many?
I think we had 11 left over this year.
Yeah, I think you should have at least 25. At 225, you should probably have 25 to 50 over.
Okay.
That's good.
Seems like good advice.
Why would you not do it? Somebody thinks because, enough to send you one.
Because it's very rare that we get a Christmas card from someone who doesn't get one from us. And I don't want to spend the extra 25, 30 bucks to have 25 more in reserve, only to have them then have to be recycled because we didn't send them out. I want to hit that sweet spot where I got a few extras.
Here's the deal. You give me the extras, and I'll make a list of who I'm going to send them out to, people that I know would love to get a card from Jason Wilde. Before they are sent out, you must approve of any of those so that you don't have to throw any extras out.
Ronnie McKee, top of the list.
I'm not telling anybody. No, I'm not saying publicly. This is family.
Okay.
This is private. But, what is it, Jason?
Right.
You up for that?
You're going to send out Christmas cards of our family to people that aren't on our list that would like to get our Christmas card if I have extras?
But only with your approval. I have to get your approval. No one will know that list. This is not, you know, so you say you have 15 extras, and I send you a list of, let's say, 25, because God 15, knows whoever you might want.
People.
And then you check the 15, and I send them, because I know this, you send yours out like October the 5th or something.
That's not true. Early. No, we cut it pretty close this year. It took me a while.
Okay.
My coupon almost expired. Yeah, it's a whole thing.
Right. The people that would get them from you a little late, they don't mind. They're just so honored to have it from you.
Okay.
So, are you willing to do this?
You know,
what
Marquette.
Do you mean, oh my God! What is the problem with you?
Marquette is in the Sweet 16. I was all excited. I'll make you a deal. I get to decide who makes or doesn't make the cut, but one of the people has to be Shaka Smart.
I do not have his address, but I'll take care of that. Yes, one will be to Shaka Smart.
So this is a professional radio segue from my Christmas card list.
I know we shouldn't talk about this, but real quick, go.
No, it's not.
One has to be Greg Gard, right? If Shocker Smart gets one, Greg Gard has to be on the list.
For it, Gary.
Sure, Greg Gard. I would be happy to. I don't know if Greg wants one from me, but I would be happy to put him on the list as well.
And if you're sending to both of them, you have to send one to Sundance
Everybody,
Wigs.
Let me just tell you, Jason, for people that don't get it, everybody would love one from you because it's not about you. It's all about the girls. So everybody loves to, I think, for Christmas and stuff, you know, find Jason, whatever. But to have some information about your kids is awesome. I think people should do that more often. And they don't, but that's
you can have this conversation with Evan Cohen, who is against the holiday card, as we established on our show
time. That's so pathetic. Needs therapy.
You're gonna deliver one of my extra Christmas cards to Shaka Smart because I am.
Well, I mean, I know I won't. Well, yeah, but I'll get an address that it can be mailed to. I'm not personally gonna deliver it.
Oh well, then I have to reconsider. Help me with this because I brought this up on Monday. When Justin Garcia was in as our cousin's sub of the day, you know, I watched his post-game interview on CBS. I have been a fan of his from afar. I've never met him. I've never interviewed him. I mean, I've never met him since he's been at Marquette. I wrote a story, and I interviewed him when he won at VCU, and I wrote something in the aftermath of that for the State Journal. But that was the only time. It was a phone interview. I've never met him in person. And I have not met him in person since he's been the Marquette coach. I have admired him from afar. And we stole his milkshake thing with our softball team that the girls were on last spring. I just really like how much he preaches and appears to live connectivity and love and team bonding and everything like that. What I said to Justin Garcia when he was in as our cousin sub is that because I'm a reporter, and because there is this natural requirement to be skeptical, I always worry about people that I really like being too good to be true and not being the authentic thing that I think they are. Can you tell me that I don't have to worry about Shaka Smart during that in that department?
Well, you don't have to, but here's the dilemma that everyone has who's the voice of the school. If it wasn't true, I'm not going to tell you it's not true.
But you would find a way to let us know that you were.
Not anymore. The expectations are that given the negativity of social media, you can't do that anymore. I mean, you used to be able to, but you can't anymore. So, I mean, then I accept that. But yeah, he's an amazing person. I told him once, I don't listen to you. I just watch you. And I would tell people the same way. Just observe him. You learn more observing him than, like, when he said all these things, you know, like, by the way, everybody's doing the same thing. Like, everybody hugs their players now. Danny Hurley at UConn hugs his player. He hugs his players. And then everybody talks about loving, you know, like when you hear players that win, like, oh, I love my team. The connectivity, all this stuff. I don't know if they stole it from Shaka, but you start noticing this from all the other teams. Hugging? Everybody hugs each other before they go into the game when they announce the starting lineup. I've been watching basketball a long time. Hugging is new.
Okay.
That's good. That's, well, and, you know, loving and crying when you lose. Everybody cries now when you lose.
All right. So here's my thing, though. I think you can watch.
Did I answer your question?
Not really.
He's an amazing person. Okay. Then I'll tell you, and people can believe it or not they want. He's an amazing person who's driven by two things. He's driven to win. No one has ever wanted to win more than he does. But he's equally driven to change the lives of young men and give them an example. And I don't know exactly how to describe it, but he wants to make them better, make their lives better. And that is every bit as important to him as winning. But don't for a second think. You watch him. You'll see how badly he wants to win.
Yeah, I guess
by his emotions and energy.
All right, so my issue with what you said there is you're right. That I don't disagree that there are more coaches and more teams that talk about this and act like it is important. But I think you can also watch, if you watched enough basketball games, which I felt like I did for the first two rounds because that is my favorite sports time on the calendar, you can see the guys that it feels a little more forced and a little less authentic. Wouldn't you acknowledge that? Like, Rick Pitino hugging guys, I'm not sure that it comes off as convincing as when Shaka does it, for example.
Right. I'll say this. This is not – Shaka's been doing this for some time. And, in fact, I don't know, it was maybe his first year, he mentioned all this stuff. And I said, well, like, haven't you said that before? I mean, he's spoken of this, that this is a special group. And I said, yeah. And I said, so what's different? He goes, they listen to me. I thought, yeah, that's the key. They buy into it. They believe it. He's obviously, as any coach, can have another group that aren't necessarily as don't buy into it the same way. And I think if I had to pick a player that I think is reflective of that to the buy-in would be Oso. But again, that's what it comes down to. You say these things, and some players don't buy into it. These guys all buy into it. They believe it. And, you know, clearly no one has ever said about Shaka going way back that he isn't genuine and that he is.
So, Homer, you mean to tell me Kevin O'Neill's not hugging players?
Ooh, good reference.
No, the hugging started. You can go back and check. I'm talking about pregame hugs. Now, this is the hugging I'm talking about.
But do you have a problem with hugging or no? Is that too much for you?
I think that's less than 10 years old.
Okay, fine. All right.
I mean, they've had that for years. They've had like little – it's not signals. You know, they high-five, yeah. But high-five wasn't good enough. So it's like a five or six things they do with a certain player. But hugging, somebody can go check it out. I'm willing to have your institute look into it. I would say the hugging – the four games is less than 10 years old by anyone.
All right, well, they got North Carolina State, big fella in the paint now. He's been doing – he's been playing lights out, hasn't he?
He has been, but North he doesn't State. Rebound. He's an odd player. He's as big as he is, and he's as wide as a house. But the guy they played against, Colorado, was very big and more of a force around the basket. The other guy that's a concern at NC State is Diarra, who's very good around the basketball. Marquette, I'm curious to see how they defend those two guys because the wide body guy is more of a shooter from 6'10", and Diarra does much more. He does everything. And so, but Marquette should win the game. I mean, they're an 11 seed because they had to win five games in a row to get into the tournament. That's just incredible. You set that up assuming no one could ever win five in a row. I mean, they probably shouldn't have even been in their ACC tournament, but they put everybody in, and so then going, there's no way. These guys will lose. The most they'll do is win a couple games. And they beat everybody. So they clearly are playing as well as just about anybody in the country.
The big fella to which Gary and Homer refer is DJ Burns, who is a big fella. He's listed at 6'9", 275. And he reminds me of Tausch. He's got great feet.
Yes.
Right?
I was going to mention that, but I was going to say Tausch must have been just like that in high school. That good. But I don't think Tausch was that big in high school. So I was afraid to use that connection. But excellent. Great feet and has a good shot, too.
Yeah, he does. It is odd, the rebounding aspect. Hey, what did you think of what you saw from Kolek in the first two rounds. Sydney and I sat together on the couch and listened to you and watched the game. That Varsity app worked fine for me, by the way, just for the record. Yeah. But I am curious. You know, there was obviously the oblique injury that kept him out down the stretch run, but he's a fun player to watch and so good. What did you think of how he played, and how good do you feel about him moving forward?
Well, the MVP are the doctors, whoever decided to sit him out as long as they did, because he played 37 and 39 minutes.
Or like right.
After sitting out for 6.5 games, clearly meaning he probably could have played sooner. Yeah, the crazy part is no one could have anticipated he would play this well and specifically this long after sitting out for 6.5 games. So credit to them. And yes, they're and other players have improved in certain areas because they had to with him gone. So if Marquette continues to move on, at some point the discussion will be that the oblique injury helped them become mm-hmm. a better team. But that'll be determined. In order to get that discussion, they'd probably have to make the Final Four. I mean, this is a game that they're going to be favored to win, and they should be. But the game after that, either Duke or Houston, that's a different level when you then get to the Final Four, and then you bring up all totally different stories. Because right now, they've been as high as 2 in the country. They're 8th-ranked team in the country. So they're doing what they were supposed to do, and that would include a win over NC State. So all the great stories. But the ability to him not just play as well, but to play that many minutes. There's mm-hmm. nobody who expected that many minutes. And he had to play that many against Western Kentucky to win. And then he's been fantastic. He's special. They compared him to Jason Webb because And it's all because of the number of rebounds. There are point guards that get scoring and assists, but few that have as many rebounds as he has. One, he's very good at it, and two, Marquette needs him to do it. So
yeah.
That's going to make – so the stats he puts up are going to be legendary as well because of the importance of him as a rebound.
I just – Sydney and I were talking as we were watching, and I just kept talking to her about how he seems to be always in control – and he sees the floor so well. And I mentioned this to you. You know, I was a little confused because I felt like Jay Wright had been out of coaching for too long to have coached against Kolek, but maybe I'm getting the timeline wrong. But he made the comment that early on that they always forced Kolek to go to his right because he couldn't, because he's left-handed, and that they would back off of him at the three-point line because he couldn't shoot it very well. And the fact that he now has become the player that he is, I told Sid, that's proof of how much you can improve if you work your tail off. But I am amazed at how he's always under control and the way he sees the floor. I just think that he really is special. He is really fun to watch.
Yeah, he's under control except when it comes to talking to everybody. Loves to talk to everybody. Loves to be in a verbal battle. The verbal battle when he first started used to be with he and Shaka yelling back and forth all the time. It's almost like Almagor. Now he's always in a battle with a player or somebody on the sidelines. He just
what about with you?
He loves to irritate people. No, I have to work at it. He's a natural. I think maybe it's from being from Rhode Island, or maybe he got it from his dad. But yeah, he's always in the middle of something, looking at something, saying something. But he's an incredibly skilled player who sees the court. And then to me, the most important part he serves is his ability to rebound, which Marquette needs him to do, in addition mm-hmm. to all the other things. And just so you know, I claim that his three-point shot has gotten better because he's elevated it more. I call it almost a hang time three. And I asked him, and he said, and I told him, look, because he kind of said no, and I said, I checked, and it's you're like 5% higher. Tony Smith was next to me and said, Tyler, you should know that Homer makes stuff up all the time. And I go, yeah, I didn't make that up. And Tyler goes, well, maybe we need a new radio play-by-play guy. And I said, fine, maybe we need a new point guard.
Ooh.
So he said,
so you did talk. So you did do this.
He loves to battle even with me. We had a debate
over
whether he's better than Travis Diener. Somebody heard I said that, and he asked me, and I said, yeah, I mean, Travis is better than you. He goes, you really said that? I said, yeah, yesterday, today, and tomorrow. I said, but why would you care? What do you mean? He goes, I'm 69 years old. You would just turn to me if I were you and go, you old fart, you don't know what you're doing anymore. Just basketball teams go away. He turns to me and he goes, well, maybe I'm nicer than you. So I don't have a much of a relationship with any of the players that much, but with him it's hard not to because he likes interaction and feedback and a battle, and
nice.
That's part of what makes him a very good player. Yeah.
All right, well, let me know if he wants to be on the Christmas card list. Homer,
decide. Do you want him on the Christmas card list?
No.
And then if you send him one, he'll feel obligated to send you one, and then
goes life. I don't think he will. I don't think he's in that club. I can check with him. But whether or not, just so people understand, because with Tauscher, you have to be careful. Jason decides whether someone gets sent one. Can I get an address for Tyler Kolek? Yes. The one person I felt best with about the win from Marquette, I felt best about his dad. His dad was a really good player, and I think he loves watching his kid play, and I think it would have been devastating to him if they had made the Sweet 16. So the first person I thought of was his dad when they won.
All right, you Homer and Tony will be on the call Friday night, tip time 6:09 Central.
Right, and Tony and I will be on the little show Thursday, because I don't leave till Friday morning, 5 to 5:15, and then Gary Ellerson, who can't be on Friday because there is no show, is going to help out for the final 45 minutes of the little show on Thursday. And lastly, do you want me to get Tyler Kolek's address to send him a Wilde Christmas card?
I don't think Tyler Kolek wants the Wilde Christmas card. I think he'll be fine without it, but tell him that we are really enjoying watching him play. Thanks, okay. Homer.
I will do that. Bye.
All right,
that is bye. Steve the there Homer True.
There it is.
Why
do I feel like you guys have some sort of a contentious relationship a little
we
bit?
We don't at all. He's just difficult. And after the many, many years that I've been doing radio with him, I enjoy it. I like the challenge. Like, I like the challenge of getting Ted Thompson to answer a question. I like the challenge of talking with Homer. We still have one more segment left in the 10 o'clock hour, and not that you would know it by the fact that it's 11:01. More Wilde and Tausch straight ahead. Stick around.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans, this is 100.5 ESPN.
Prize Picks is America's number one fantasy sports app with over 3 million active members. They are the easiest and most exciting way to play daily fantasy sports. All you do, pick more or less on a 2-6 player stat projection and watch the winnings roll in. Whether it's tournament season or the fight for playoff home court, there's no shortage of high-stakes basketball moments this time of year. Prize Picks even offers injury insurance so that your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets hurt. For basketball games, if you have a player who exits the game in the first half and does not return in the second, Prize Picks will have your back and not count that as a loss. Prize Picks is really simple to play. I can make my picks and submit my entry in less than 60 seconds. Prize Picks also offers weekly promotions and special offers for the biggest moments in sports. Download the app today and use code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a deposit match up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
You, rah, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by Stoughton Trailers. Big trailers and big opportunity at Stoughton Trailers. Learn more about why a career at Stoughton Trailers might be for you. Go to stojobs.com. As the Wisconsin men's basketball season comes to an end, more news of players potentially headed out the Kohl Center door. Star guard A.J. Storr has announced he will pursue the NBA draft while maintaining his college eligibility. That means Storr will likely participate in workouts and a combine for NBA teams without hiring an agent, and if he so chooses, can return to Wisconsin next season. During his only season in Madison, A.J. Storr led the team, averaging over 16 points per game.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
Hey,
Hungry? And your heart is ticking for chicken? Well, take a quick turn into Quick Trip, because we got
no ordinary chicken.
Yeah, go wild with wings. Next level super wings with trusty sidekick and sauces. Or let's talk tender. Quick Chick tenders. Love me tenders. Love me some Quick tenders. Ours are bigger, better, tastier. Or if you're feeling good old school comfort fried chicken, we got it. Hand breaded down homier than anywhere. Quick Trip, saving your nuggets from ordinary.
What does it take to make a diamond? Extreme heat and pressure and about a billion years. But you can't wait that long. What do? You go to Goodman's Jewelers. I'm John Hayes from Goodman's Jewelers. There's a reason we are the diamond store of Madison. Since 1933, we've provided outstanding service and selection to our customers. And that in turn has helped to establish countless great memories through the years. Goodmansjewelers.com, located at 220 State Street. Truly a destination worth reaching.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
You're probably being overwhelmed with information about semaglutide, the game-changing FDA-approved weight loss treatment. Jim Rutledge here. I was like you. I didn't know what it was until I saw Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. He can walk you through the benefits. He can tell you if it's right for you, and then you could come up with a plan to change your life with a workout plan and semaglutide. With that plan, I dropped from 20% body fat to 10% body fat, and I dropped over 20 pounds of fat and kept my muscle. You can do the same thing. Go see Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Our clock is all jacked up because Homer wanted to send out my extra Christmas cards to people who might not, who might want them, which threw off the timing of our Marquette. They're in the Sweet 16. We don't need to be talking about my Christmas cards. Fair?
Fair enough.
Who sent the first Christmas card between you and Goody? Who initiated that first?
I suppose I would have asked him for his address. So that would have been, and then he said, well, make sure you give me yours. So this would have been, God, let's see, the girls were born in 2010 and 2011, so this would probably have been 2011. That would have been the Christmas that I would have done it for. Like, again, for those that don't understand the dynamic there, like, he came up on the scouting side, and I came up on the reporting side. We're basically the same age. He's a little bit younger than me. But, like, I've known the guy forever. I don't hate him. I do disagree with some of the things he did.
Well, who thinks that you hate that?
I think because we can get into this in the 11 o'clock hour, but I think because the praise of him is almost universal, that if you are negative in any way, you must hate the guy, which is just not true.
Oh, well, no, you're just doing your job.
Thank you, Gary. And part of my job is to tell you, calling all Packers fans, Mark Tauscher here. How's that, Jesse? Did that sound
pretty
like
good?
Him at all?
Pretty good.
American Family Insurance wants to see you and a friend in Detroit for this year's draft. You can enter the Dream Draft Day sweepstakes. No truth to the rumor that Jesse will accompany you for your chance to win two tickets to the draft, travel and hotel accommodations to and from Detroit, and a custom jersey, and even more. So go to amfam.com/Packers. That's amfam.com/Packers to learn more and to enter. There's no purchase necessary. This is my favorite part. American Family Insurance Company, SI, and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin. The 11 o'clock hour starts very late. It'll start with, oh, God knows what it'll start with. Homer will probably call back with more people on the list of Christmas cards. So stick around. Gary Ellerson is our outstanding cousin sub of the day. Cousin subs, we believe in better. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
Hi, this is Dave Kane. You're listening to Madison's Home of the Bucks, a Good Karma brand radio station, 100.5 ESPN WTLX Monona, Madison.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison and streamers everywhere. I'm Jesse Nelson. Sports Center brought to you by ESPN Madison on YouTube. Subscribe to watch all your favorite daily shows. Mr. Irrelevant with Alex Strofe, exclusively streaming every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And special featured content. Subscribe today to watch ESPN Madison on YouTube. The Milwaukee Bucks, you got to watch a little extra basketball last night. Double overtime at Fiserv Forum, but it did not break the way of the Bucks. Final score, the Los Angeles Lakers 128, the Milwaukee Bucks 124. Lakers get the win despite LeBron James sitting out last night's game with an ankle injury. Giannis led the way for the Bucks with a triple-double, 29 points, 21 rebounds, 11 assists in the loss. Damian Lillard had 27 for the Bucks, including a big shot at the end of the first overtime that looked like it could be a potential Dame Time game winner until the Lakers tied the game with a couple of free throws. Bucks next in action tomorrow, visiting the New Orleans Pelicans. 7 o'clock tip right here on Madison's Home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN. College basketball, Marquette gearing up for its Sweet 16 matchup against 11-seed NC State Friday night in Dallas. Shaka Smart appeared this morning on Unsportsmanlike on ESPN Radio.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Tausch begins now. Now, Gary, have you ever been to Brazil?
Yes. No.
Do you want to go to Brazil? Do you want the Packers to play the Eagles in Brazil?
Are you guys going to send a little show to Brazil?
I don't think we've gotten that far in our conversations. Tausch said he was not going, even though he speaks very fluent Portuguese. So maybe we need a cousin sub. So if it's you, me, and Jesse, are you going?
Yeah, I'm in.
Okay. As long as the company picks up the tab, because I'm not going on my own dime.
Right. Yeah, I'm in.
So this is, I still think that if a member of the Browns says on a podcast that the Browns are going to Brazil, and maybe he shouldn't have said that now the fact that we're pretending, maybe, or maybe I'm wrong, but I'm guessing this seems like something, Jesse, that they would have already decided. Like, they wouldn't have waited this long. But nevertheless...
So, I agree, but then why did...
The National Football League.
But then, like, they've made multiple announcements saying the Brazil game featuring the Eagles. Like, it doesn't just say the Brazil game where they're just omitting the teams. Like, they keep pointing out that the Eagles are playing.
Right. So it's their home game they're giving up. They announced that first, and then they said the opponent would be named later. And Mark Murphy yesterday at the NFL meetings was asked about Brazil, and here is what he said.
I think we'll obviously hear soon on that with the league. Yeah, we're very supportive of international play. The one issue with Green Bay, though, are the size of our airport and the size of our runway. And we want to make sure that we're not at a competitive disadvantage in terms of how long it's going to take us to get to Brazil. There's some some thought that we might have to bus to Milwaukee and then fly, just some of those things. But, and I anticipate probably within the week we'll find out. So it's either us or Cleveland. If they choose us, we'll welcome it. I think it would be exciting. It would be the first game ever in Brazil. Could be exciting, but want to make sure that we're, some of those things are working.
Okay, the fact that he's standing by a grandfather clock that chimed while he was talking is only the second most ridiculous thing in that audio clip. Now, again, I don't hate Mark Murphy, but are you kidding me? You guys wonder why I say I like Jordan Love all the time. This is the kind of stuff, this is why. Because I'm going to make fun of him, and it doesn't mean I hate him. But you don't want to go to Brazil because your runways at Austin Straubel Airport are not long enough to accommodate the plane you would take to Sao Paulo, and you might have to bus to Milwaukee and take a plane from there. That is the competitive disadvantage that you have suggested publicly.
Okay. I'm going to get with you on this.
Help me out here, Gary.
Okay, fine. Because when I heard that too, the runway? Really? Okay. Bus to Milwaukee? Come on, Mark. What are you doing, bro? Help me out, Mark. Jeez. You know what I feel like? I feel like the NFL wants the Green Bay Packers to be the team. I'm not sure the Green Bay Packers want to go.
That's exactly what I feel like.
Yeah,
and we're searching for excuses.
The whole London trip wasn't good for them. I just don't think that he wants to. Matt LaFleur maybe doesn't want to deal with all that again. Because it's nothing to bust to Milwaukee.
As someone who makes the Milwaukee Green Bay drive regularly, I understand that it is a slight inconvenience. I get it. But you don't want to play? Right. And you don't want to play in Brazil because you would have to bus to Milwaukee to fly to Brazil. Again,
What plane is he talking about?
Right.
Do we know?
I was not next to the grandfather clock when this question was being answered. So I wasn't there. But they do have long enough runways. I will call over to Austin Straubel.
Please do an investigative report on this.
Yeah, we're looking for the plane size.
Because they do have pretty darn large planes that they take to all their road games. They are sufficient to get them to Los Angeles, to Miami. Like, they take long trips with this team. That's the first time I have ever heard the runway issue be brought up. And again, 767, 757, I don't know what planes they take to Brazil. But
I did find an article about runway length and how it impacts private flights.
Okay.
Here we go. All right. This is from stratosjets.com.
Well, that's where I usually like to get my jet setting information.
It's important to understand that every private jet has certain runway length limitations referred to as takeoff and landing distances. These distances vary based on the size and weight of your aircraft. These requirements are set forth to enable jet aircraft to meet with the Federal Aviation Administration regulation that requires private jets to operate within 60% of a runway. This means private jets have to take off from the first half of the runway in order to comply with FAA rules. Aircraft with heavy weight or poor climb rates have to either reduce cargo, fuel, or passenger count, or take off from a longer runway.
So what do we have at Austin Straubel? Do we know?
I don't know. I will put this...
It's legit!
I understand it's legit, Jesse. Here's the thing. So I don't know if they take 747s, 757s. They're not taking little, like, tiny, like, this isn't Major League where the Indians have to travel on the little prop plane and Corbin Burnson is afraid to that he's going to crash. He's wearing his little mask over his eyes. Like, they fly on very large planes. Now, the Packers in recent years, because of other personnel that go on the trips and members of the board and everything else, they do have two separate planes now. That is the team plane and then, like, the extraneous staff plane and board members, etc. But they still, these are not small airplanes. These are not tiny little commuter airplanes. These are jumbo jets. And so I don't know. Regardless, even if this is accurate, let's forget about how ridiculous this is for a second. And let's just say, even if there would be the issue of they can't take off from Austin Straubel in the plane they need to get to Brazil. Frankly, I prefer this conversation over the ridiculousness of the Packers complaining that with 9 years left on their lease, that the mayor wants them to not try and get out of some of the money that they have agreed to pay the city. My issue with this story is it's a ridiculous thing to say. I just don't understand. I understand you can't say, look, we don't want to go. The NFL wants us to go. We're trying to get out of it. So we don't, but that's what it is. I think am I crazy to think that that's the bottom line?
That's the bottom line to me. I don't think they want to go.
Right, and I don't blame them.
Yeah, I don't want to go either.
And look, for those that don't think I criticize the head coach enough, on this program, he handled the London trip poorly.
He did.
His mood was clearly, I don't want to go. And
not there.
He sent really bad messaging, and he had his quarterback, who was trying to basically usurp that by saying, "Look, you got to embrace this. We got to go enjoy it. Go a few days." Mm-hmm. Like LaFleur had them go the minimum amount of time early, which perhaps factored into how they faded in the second half. I don't know, but
no
his attitude sucked in 2022, and I don't think that even if he acts publicly like he would want to do this, he doesn't want to do it. Football ops. You played in the league, Gary. Explain this to me.
Yeah.
You guys are all creatures of habit. And playing a game in Brazil is outside of the normal rhythm of your week, even if it's the first week of the season. Is it not?
Well, too many distractions. You're going to Brazil. I mean, just too much going on there. And you're out of really your regimen of things that you normally do every week. Now you probably got a bus to practice, go to a facility that you aren't familiar with. You got the training staff there. They got to get familiar with their surroundings. I mean, there's just a lot of moving parts that you really don't want to deal with, let alone if you're talking about the time change. So that's always an issue with players. And then how comfortable are you going over there and getting back? Because you probably got to play unless they give you a bye week after that. And with the Packers last year, that when they went to London, chose not to have a bye week, which was even awful. That hurt the players. So they fumbled that whole trip to London in so many different ways. If they do go, hopefully they learn from that, and hopefully Matt LaFleur embraces it. But I just feel like the Packers really don't want to go.
Yeah, I think that's probably the bottom line. And that's, again, I understand you can't say that publicly. I don't think that answer was a great way to handle it.
Yeah,
it's laughable. So, again, we'll see what happens. I fully anticipate, because my understanding was that the Browns really do want to go.
Yeah, they want to go in a worse way. They want the Packers to be there.
And you could argue, as Tausch did before he went on vacation, Jesse, that having to play the Eagles in Sao Paulo is better than having to play the Eagles late in the season in Philly when you're competing with them for playoff positioning.
If you can get the Eagles week one at a neutral site as opposed to, like, Thanksgiving weekend in Philly on Sunday Night Football, I'd rather play them there.
Oh, yeah, all day long.
Make the drive. The bus drive to Milwaukee would be well worth that competitive advantage, I would think.
Yeah.
Cleveland, known for its big runways. They're definitely all in. They want every international game. They got no problem flying out of there.
They've got a very nice airport, yes. All right, we need to play some trivia. Jesse, what have you selected as today's category? It is Wednesday, but Tausch isn't here Does that mean we still get Wisconsin Geography Wednesday?
Of course it does. We love it too much. Wisconsin Geography Wednesday is today's category.
All right. So, Gary, since you are our cousin sub of the day, cousin subs we believe in better, you wore with the Packers 42?
Yeah, 42 with the Packers, yeah.
So yeah, 4 42. Plus 2 is 6, because I'm not going to make Jesse answer 42 calls. So
okay. No,
caller 6 for trivia. Caller 6, 844-770-3776. 844-770-3776. Caller 6 for Wilde and Tausch trivia right coming up next. Want to remind you, I was trading emails with Danny and Chad yesterday at Steinhoffels. They take great care of us. They take great care of all their customers. We love our new bed that we got, and now I have to get a new frame since I broke it. And they're there for us with that as well. And they are there for you with their Out with the Old and In with the New sale. The Steinhoffels New for Spring sale is going on right now. It's the perfect time to update your bedroom, which is what we did, or add more seating to your dining room, or make your living room feel new again. And get a great night's sleep on a new mattress. Whatever it might be, Steinhoffels has something for every style and for every budget. And with their 60-month financing, your new room just got more affordable. So shop in-store or online at steinhoffels.com. Caller 6 for trivia, 844-770-3776. We'll play next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
Hi, I'm Madison Money Guy, Christian Finfrock with Retirement Income Strategies. And what sets us apart is we're an independent, family-run office. We help clients like you understand the financial world and build a portfolio that's in your best interest. To learn more, go to MadisonMoneyGuy.com.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
Good Karma Brands is proud to be an equal opportunity employer. Our policy is to provide equal opportunity employment, development, and advancement to all current and potential teammates. If you are an organization that maintains a job bank, provides employment information, or gives job referrals, you may request to be placed on the station's mailing list for future career opportunities. To learn more about careers at Good Karma Brands, please email careers@goodkarmabrands.com.
Cousin Subs was founded in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1972 and has been a member of the Madison community for decades. This year, Cousins has expanded their footprint in the Madison area by opening new locations in Stoughton and Sun Prairie, in addition to existing locations on East Washington Avenue, Monona, and Lodi. Order your favorite subs online or via our app for delivery or pickup. Eat in or grab them to go through our drive-thru for a better sub experience. Cousin Subs, we believe in better.
Get your team together. Softball is back for 2024. Jesse Nelson here. Registration for Madison School and Community Recreation's Adult Summer Softball Leagues is now open. Men's, women's, and all-gender slow pitch and women's fast pitch leagues are forming now for the summer season. MSCR Softball Leagues offer fun for every level of player and welcome all participants. Spend your summer evenings with us on the diamond. For more information and to register, go to MSCRSportsLeagues.org. That's MSCRSportsLeagues.org.
There's a good chance if you watch sports, you're getting served information about hormone optimization. What does that even mean? Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health can tell you exactly what hormone optimization means. He will take your blood work and let you know if it's right for you. If you're feeling sluggish, not losing weight like you used to, you're not gaining muscle like you used to, or you just don't feel like yourself in most aspects of your life, go see Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. In fact, sign up for the 6-week experience so you can see everything that Carbon World Health has to offer, including hormone optimization. Learn more at CarbonWorldHealth.com.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
This ain't a good time, but when is it ever? I know the perfect time, and maybe that's never. So don't you dare leave me now. Throw my heart on the ground. Just tonight.
Time for trivia. It is Wisconsin geography trivia. And while Gary might be a Wisconsin athletic icon, he is from Georgia. So we'll see how he fares. And we'll see how Tucker in Wausau fares. He is our contestant. Tucker, good morning. How are you?
Good morning. Doing well.
I know you've played trivia before. Have you played Wisconsin geography trivia before?
I think this might be my third time doing Wisconsin geography trivia.
And do you know what your track record has been?
Well, I think I was even thinking about this while I was waiting. I think this is my sixth appearance on Wilde and Tausch trivia. I think I'm batting about like 80-85%.
Wow. All right.
I had a really rough Badger sports trivia day where I think I only got one out of the three.
All right, so here's how
I did really well.
Since you've played geography trivia before, we will play it the same way we would if Tausch was here. We'll just do it with Georgia native Gary Ellerson. I will ask the questions, you will answer, and then we'll see if Gary agrees or disagrees. Question one, Tucker, is this. It may not be a great destination this time of year, since it's currently closed, but which of these is the spring break sounding name of an amusement park located in Green Bay? Is it Titletown Shores, Bay Beach, or LaFleur's La Fantasy Island?
I would be really concerned about what would be at LaFleur's Fantasy Island, but it is Bay Beach B.
Gary, agree or disagree?
Agree.
You ever been to Bay Beach? You ever been on any of the rides there, or is that not something you've partaken in, Gary?
I have.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Yeah. I've been to Bay Beach many of times.
Tucker, you too?
I have not, but I have a two-year-old son, and I do a lot of improv over in Green Bay, as I've mentioned before in trivia, so I have a feeling in the coming years I'll be making a lot of appearances at Bay Beach on the Zippin' Pippin'.
Well, keep your two-year-old off the Zippin' Pippin', but there are lots of nice slow rides that I enjoyed the girls going on when they were little, much more than I enjoy them going on the Zippin' Pippin', which sounds a little rickety, and if it was Elvis's favorite roller coaster, that makes me a little nervous. All right, question two, Tucker and Gary, is this. Latitudinally, which of these Wisconsin cities is located farthest north? Farthest north. Which of these cities farthest north? Is it Green Lake, Green Field, or Spring Green, Tucker?
I kind of wish it was more north in my neck of the woods. I'm going to go with The middle one is Greenfield.
Green Lake, Greenfield, Spring Green are your options.
I'm going to go Greenfield. Stick with the B theme.
Gary?
Probably not the way to go.
That's not the way to go.
Indeed, it's not. Greenfield, a suburb of Milwaukee, my old stomping grounds, in fact. Spring Green, Jesse, I'm sure, went on his share of field trips there. I know I did.
House on
youth.
The Rock. Yeah.
The correct answer, Green Lake. Green Lake, the farthest north. All right, Tucker, let's
Where
bounce
is Green
back.
Lake? Where is Green Lake? Real
Jesse?
For lack of a better word, it's up near Oshkosh. It's not really like people in Oshkosh would be like, that's not near Oshkosh, but that's the closest thing for people
closest
who are unfamiliar.
Closest major Wisconsin yeah. city for Green Lake. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Green Lake. All right. Okay. All right. Here's question three, Tucker. While Rio de Janeiro is in Brazil, not where the Packers will be playing if they are playing, though. While Rio de Janeiro is in Brazil, Rio is a village in Wisconsin located in which of these counties? Which of these counties for Rio? Is it Portage County, Columbia County, or Dodge County?
I'm close to Portage. I think it's between Columbia and Dodge. I'm going to... Columbia.
Gary, do you agree or disagree?
X marks the spot. I agree.
Nice. Jesse, that was a Hollywood Squares reference. I love it when Gary's on the show because we get those references. That was a dastardly question because all of those counties are in the somewhat same general vicinity, and you nailed it. Well done. It is indeed in Columbia County. I covered a few games at Rio back in my prep sports coverage days. All right, Tucker, you're 2 for 3. That means you got 3 of the possible 4 entries. And on Friday, maybe you'll be drawn when Jesse and Gary pick the winner out of the cheese fry helmet. Congratulations. Thanks for playing, buddy. We appreciate your loyalty to the show.
Yeah, thanks. Love you guys.
All right, buddy.
It's our first love you guys of the week. All right. Jesse, before Tausch departed on his vacation, sources tell me that he shared once again his love for his favorite beverage, and that is Coors Light. Tausch will tell you about that, and we will continue with Gary Ellerson, our cousin sub of the day. Next, it's Wilde and Tausch.
Mark Tauscher here for the Blue Mountains of cold, refreshing Coors Light. Whether you're celebrating your favorite team winning or you just need a moment to chill, crack open a Rocky Mountain cold Coors Light. Coors Light is brewed with a 3-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and it is cold packaged, so it is actually made to chill. The mountains on Coors Light's cold activated bottles and cans turn blue when chilled to perfection, which, besides the refreshing taste, is my favorite thing about drinking Coors Light. Refreshingly cold and only 102 calories, Coors Light is made to chill. Celebrate responsibly. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with Design Works, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. Whether you're ready to hit the road, tackle the yard, or start a new project, we get you the right products at the right prices. Like all Livingston flour or vegetable seeds, 25% off MSRP. Select 250-foot rolls of Romex Simple Wire with Ground, $109.99. And save $5 on 36-pound bags of Estate Weed and Feed, just $34.99. Plus, stock up on Easter candy, 20% off. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Goodman's Jewelers has been providing a sparkle to Madison since 1933. That's a lot of great memories.
John Hayes for Goodman's Jewelers. We've been caring for generations of customers, and during that time, our strengths have been trust, service, and selection. Those traits are who we are, and that will never change. Goodman's Jewelers, a destination worth reaching. 220 State Street, goodmansjewelers.com.
The best is at Goodman's.
Step into nostalgia with the Miller High Life Dive Bar of the Week. Listen to Rutledge and Hamilton every Thursday, and we will let you know where you can enjoy $2 Miller High Lifes. To celebrate our love for dive bars, me and Matt are going to tell you about some of our favorites, featuring one extra special dive bar that will have $2 High Lifes on special for the week. Taste the champagne of beer in its natural environment. A delightfully different dive bar in Wisconsin, like the Nitty Gritty in Middleton, the Village Green, Riley Tavern, and Remington's Tavern.
It's Chevy truck season, and there's no better time to do what you do best. No better time to get the job done in a Chevy Silverado with best-in-class standard torque and a Turbomax engine with a 5-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty that outlasts both Ford and Ram. So kick off whatever your thing is season right, because it all starts with a Chevy truck.
See your Badgerland Chevy dealer today.
Based on latest competitive data, excludes other GM vehicles, whichever comes first. See dealer for limited warranty details based on Ford and Ram 5-year, 60,000-mile warranty on gasoline engines.
Prize Picks is America's number one fantasy sports app with over 3 million active members. They are the easiest and most exciting way to play daily fantasy sports. All you do, pick more or less on a 2-6 player stat projection and watch the winnings roll in. Whether it's tournament season or the fight for playoff home court, there's no shortage of high-stakes basketball moments this time of year. Prize Picks even offers injury insurance so that your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets hurt. For basketball games, if you have a player who exits the game in the first half and does not return in the second, Prize Picks will have your back and not count that as a loss. Prize Picks is really simple to play. I can make my picks and submit my entry in less than 60 seconds. Prize Picks also offers weekly promotions and special offers for the biggest moments in sports. Download the app today and use code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a deposit match up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
From the preps,
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros,
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Time now
for Won't Know It.
If the topic is good, the guys discuss.
Just nice. The other morning I had breakfast at Tracy Sirocco's house. His mama brought out 15 flapjacks. He said, mama, take back 5 of them flapjacks. I gotta stay hungry for the Crimson Tide.
But if it's not, the show must go on. It's time for
Whoa Nelly
on Wilde and Tausch.
Are you ready for Wednesday afternoon football? How about it?
On Christmas, I am.
The apparently. NFL announcing at the owners' meetings in Florida that Christmas Day, which is a Wednesday this year on the calendar, will feature a doubleheader of NFL games. The teams that are selected to play will play on the Saturday, the weekend prior, to accommodate days off, like it would be Sunday to a Thursday game, to be able to play on Wednesday. The NFL has not always played on Christmas, although they've typically had a game if it falls around a weekend. Big deal, little deal, or no deal, Gary, that the NFL is going to have a doubleheader on a Wednesday, including a pair of afternoon games on Christmas Day.
I love it. How could you not? More football, more NFL. We're king. I love it. How could you not? Now, I don't know where the Packers are playing on that Wednesday or anything. I don't know how that's going to affect my life, But the more football, the merrier for me. How could you not, Jason Wilde?
I'll tell you how I could not. Because if the Packers are playing, that means I'm spending another Christmas covering the game. If it's at home in person, I did not have to go. And again, this is not just about me. This is about people who work at the stadium. This is about the people that work for the organization. This is about the media. This is about police officers that have to work that shift for parking cars. The NFL doesn't care about any, you know, directing traffic, I should say. The people that work in the parking lots, people that work at Kroll's. Look, I understand. It's all about money. They don't care about my or anybody else's schedule. But do we really need football on Christmas Day when it falls on a Wednesday? I get it. Hey, if it falls on Sunday, you know, you got to do what you got to do. I get it. I understand. Not taking it. But this is a intentional, let's make more money. The rich get richer. So this is what we're going to do on Christmas. And so if the Packers get picked, I'll go to work. We'll do a pregame show. We'll do all the stuff we normally do for a Packers game. But come on, it's a Wednesday. It's a Wednesday. Cash
I remember
grab.
One year. Oh, sure, but I remember one year the Packers played on Christmas. My son Brock was just a little lad. He still, Santa Claus was still circling around. And we stayed in a hotel in Green Bay. And he says, Dad, how will Santa Claus know to find us?
Great
I say,
question.
Santa Claus knows all. So we took the whole family. We brought all the presents. And guess what? Santa Claus found us in a hotel in Green Bay. And we celebrated Christmas, the whole family, in Green Bay. And Santa Claus helped facilitate that. It was the best Christmas my kids ever had. And then after that, guess what I did? We all went to the Packer game together. And then my kids wore a green and gold Santa Claus outfit. Come on, Jason.
And then Gray Rugemer wiped out Tausch's touchdown catch against the Bears with a holding penalty.
That's remember that.
It's a frequent memory that comes up on this show.
Yeah, wait,
that's great that Santa Claus knew where to find you on Christmas Day, Gary, but my Aunt Janice a couple of years ago hosting Christmas for the whole family didn't even know the Packers and Browns were playing at 3:30, scheduled the family dinner at 4:30, right in the heart of the game. And Beck and I are sitting there like, how are we going to watch? And my mom's like, it's Christmas. You can't watch football. It's Christmas. And so we were stuck. We didn't
Controversial.
Know what to do.
Yeah.
3 years in a row, Christmas Day twice, and then Christmas Eve last year. Getting right in the way of all the plans. We better not be on Christmas Day this year on a Wednesday.
Whoa, Nelly!
That'd be so frustrating. Big deal.
If we don't go to Brazil, we're playing on Christmas.
Would gladly take Brazil.
I vote Brazil, too. I've suddenly become very much pro-Brazil.
That's the trade-off for not getting the international games like everybody else. We have to play on Christmas every year.
Christmas.
It's getting very frustrating.
That's happened a lot.
Let's stick with the big deal, little deal, or no deal theme. The NFL has moved the trade deadline back to after week 9 of the NFL season, being more the midway point of the calendar. Big deal, little deal, or no deal? Gary?
Well, I think it helps. The teams are looking to make a trade. I mean, I think it. So to me, I think it's a big deal. I mean, they're doing a lot of things, small things, to try to help these teams out. To me, I think one thing they should implement, if they were ever go to 18 games, Jason, I think there should be 2 bye weeks instead of 1.
Yeah, I agree with that. And you know that they're going to try and get to 18 games. We all know that. It wouldn't hurt them to have 2 bye weeks because it's another week of content. You take the Super Bowl even further into February, and then you've got all kinds of things that you get out of that deal. So, I fully anticipate that. That said, I want to go back to Christmas for a second.
Oh, fine. He's backing the truck all the way up. Okay.
I will say this, that the challenge in the NFL, and you know this from having played, I always joke about Thanksgiving. You know what they call Thanksgiving in the NFL? They call it Thursday because they still practice on Thanksgiving. If you have a Sunday game, you can't take Thursday off because you're playing on Sunday. Christmas to me is different whether you're celebrating it as a Christian or you're celebrating it as a secular holiday, whatever you view it as. Christmas is just different, and that's the one. You said this, and you were absolutely right earlier in the show, and if you missed it, you can find it on Wisconsin On Demand. They're taking a shot at the NBA. The NBA was like the one league that played on Christmas every year. It was like their big day, and the NFL's like, oh, I don't think so. We're going to take care of that for you. Good luck with your numbers against our games. We're going to put some games on Christmas. So yes, Gary's right about that.
And then this year the NBA's like, finally, it's a Wednesday. We get it back. And the NFL says,
right.
Nope.
Exactly.
Guess what we're going to do? What if it was the Bucks though? The Bucks and Packers playing on Christmas Day. That would be quite a conflict in the state of Wisconsin.
Right.
It's been two of the last 3 years.
Yep.
They've done it.
Right.
And then last year was Christmas Eve, and then the Bucks played Christmas Day. It's been very much Christmas sports stuff to keep track of, at least. I don't know if I'd say attentively watching all of them, but you got to keep track of it.
I am convinced that the Packers will get one of the Christmas games after I saw that out.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Yeah,
the idea of snow falling on Christmas night.
Going to love all that.
The video, the TV is going to. And by the way, if they played a primetime Christmas night game, I'm okay with that. Because if it's at home, I leave after most of the Christmas festivities at our house have concluded. I am lucky in that at this point in my career, I don't travel very often. I travel to Minnesota and Chicago and then the playoffs. Mm-hmm. Although I didn't do the playoffs this year. It would suck to have to fly out on Christmas Eve and go cover a road game on Christmas Day and miss your family.
True.
That would be how I would feel about it as a reporter. But if they're at home on Christmas night, I'm okay with that. They've done that before, as Gary mentioned, and that's not the end of the world. Yeah. So I'm all right with that.
Packers, Lions, and Christmas
Packers,
night.
Lions and Packers. Yeah, Lions and Packers on Christmas night.
They always play Detroit early in the year. Let's flip that this time around.
Well, maybe they can play on Thanksgiving and on Christmas against them. They can spend all their holidays together.
Holiday special, yeah.
All right, that's it for Woe Nelly. I want to remind you that Fleet Farm is now hiring. It's the perfect time for you to join a team where you can learn every day, have fun, be yourself. Plus, you'll get 20% off as a team member. That's the discount for team members for them and their families. So apply today at careers.fleetfarm.com. That's careers.fleetfarm.com. Find all you need at your local store or online at fleetfarm.com. We'll wrap things up with Gary Ellerson, our cousin sub of the day. Next, it's Wilde and Tausch.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
Mark Tauscher here for the great team at Everlight Solar. Well, the return of baseball and the countdown to the start of basketball's playoffs also mean the days are getting longer. And more sunlight means more encouragement to make the energy switch to Everlight Solar. Wouldn't you love to have a way to save money and save the planet? Well, good news, there is a way. It's by making the switch to solar. Our family is one of many who have made the switch to solar over the last several years. But when we first started, we weren't exactly sure what to do. So when we met with the Everlight Solar team and they outlined the entire process and educated us on the benefits of making the switch, it was super simple. Join us in saving a ton of money and creating a greener environment for our family and the community by switching to solar. Learn more and schedule a free consultation at EverlightSolar.com. That's EverlightSolar.com.
You, Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Stroff.
This Badger Minute brought to you by the Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's home for craft beer and pub food since 1994. Find the Great Dane nearest you at GreatDanePub.com. Following a disappointing end to the Wisconsin men's basketball team's season on Friday night, the 12th seeded James Madison in the NCAA tournament, fan favorite sophomore Connor Asijan announced Sunday on social media that he intends to enter the transfer portal. During Asijan's freshman season in 2022-2023, he started 19 games and played over 27 minutes on average per night. During his sophomore campaign, that jumped to 0 games started and only 7 minutes per game. Asijan did not see any playing time in the final 3 games of the Badgers season.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
As you're putting your spring calendar together, we'd love to have you join us Saturday, May 18th for Mark Osiki's 6th Annual Casting for Kids Fishing Tournament to support the American Family Children's Hospital, UW-Carbone Cancer Center. We're on the Madison Chain of Lakes early, then back at the Alliant Energy Center for 2:30 happy hour, dinner, and live and silent auctions with cool autographed hockey items, guided tours, and a brand new fishing boat. There's even more on our website, castingforkids.org. Help us help the kids. castingforkids.org.
Zimbrick Chevrolet.
When was the last time you had your oil changed or your tires rotated? Do you need new tires, a battery, perhaps some windshield wipers? Zimbrick Chevrolet Service Center is equipped to help you with routine maintenance, major repairs, and everything in between. Get your free battery inspection coupon and schedule an appointment today at ZimbrickChevrolet.com. Don't overpay. Shop Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie.
Main Street, Sun Prairie, Zimbrick Chevrolet.
Join Prairie Athletic Club and spring forward your membership today. Hi, this is Sarah Tauscher encouraging you to save now until the end of August when you join the pack. The Platinum membership is everything you want and more, including Pilates, hot yoga, bar, unlimited training zone, and boot camp classes. Discover the ultimate wellness experience tailored just for you. Not a member? Not a problem. Guests are welcome daily. Head to prairieathletic.com or stop in today for all their membership specials. Prairie Athletic Club, family fun community.
Hey, it's Jesse Nelson. Join Adam Mertz and me for the grand opening of the Bogey Factory in Verona. Experience indoor virtual golf like never before, including the same state-of-the-art TrackMan technology as seen on the PGA Tour. The Bogey Factory, Saturday, April 13th from 10 a.m. to noon.
Stoughton Health, in collaboration with patient and family advisors, seeks to advance the healthcare experience at Stoughton Health by providing a forum for past patients and families to provide feedback on a variety of healthcare and other related topics. Advisors offer constructive feedback on their personal journey at Stoughton Health, helping to elevate the patient experience and increase satisfaction. Interested? Please call Amy at 608-873-2308.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
I say go, baby, go, go, go.
All right, we're almost out of time. Now, Gary, you're going to be here for 2 more days.
Yes.
Thank you for your service.
Who am I going to be with? Who's going to be with?
You're going to be with Jesse.
Okay.
Who doesn't know where Green Lake is, apparently, based on the talking
now,
text
line. I knew this was going to happen. All these people that are uppity about their geography are saying, oh, it's west of Fond du Lac. It's near Ripon. That's Oshkosh for those of us who aren't from near Oshkosh.
All right. Well, in fairness, they are more accurate than you, but either way, it is farthest north of the 3 towns that you listed, which is all that I care about in trivia.
We were factually accurate.
Gary, I'm going to pop in tomorrow at some point because no one should have to do 6 hours of radio with just Jesse.
Well, that's rude.
So, but fair.
Okay.
So I'll swing by on my day that I'm supposed to be taking off so I can spend some time with you guys. Thanks for stepping in these 3 days. I've told you this before. I love it when we get to work together. I think the world of you, and it's been really fun today. And I'll talk to you for a little while tomorrow, but not 3 hours because I got stuff to do.
Well, that's okay. Same here. And make sure you catch me tomorrow with Homer on the Little Show.
On the Little Show, which it'll be even littler for you than normal because it'll be Tony Smith for 15 minutes and you for the final 45 alongside Homer. It's the Homer Hour 5 to 6 every weekday on 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee. And there'll be no show on Friday because Marquette will be playing on Friday night. All right, that's it for us today. Thanks for coming along for the ride. Thanks to Bryan, Bulaga, and Homer. And thanks to you. Have a great day. Take care. Be good.
Miss any of today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin? Commercial-free full show podcasts are available free.